What's up, boys and girls? Welcome to the BFF's YouTube channel. Make sure you guys tap the bell, subscribe, like the video, and comment down below.
All right, BFFs.
Yes, sir.
Willis Reed game. Do you know who Willis Reed is, Josh?
Do I know who what?
Willis Reed.
I don't think so.
He's some old school. He's even before my time, but he's like famously, he was played for the Knicks and he was like injured. And, like, showed up with, like, a bum leg or something, played, like, 1 minute. That's what I'm doing here because I am under the weather.
You sound sick.
I am sick.
You got the little red around the nose.
Well, that's burn. I was at the Kentucky Derby and just sat in 90. Have you ever worn sunblock? Well, I was in Miami for a month and then went to Kentucky for the Derby, sat outside, is in one of the few seats that was in the sun, and just got assassinated for
Six hours. Do you get burned in the Kentucky Derby after you've been in Miami for a month?
I have no idea. That shows you just how strong the sun was. So the nose is burned, but yeah, I...
You got the Iverson mentality today. You're not missing game day.
Correct.
I love it.
Show up.
And it's a well-known fact. I've been hanging out a lot with a girl, this girl, Silvana, and she doesn't go to sleep. She just doesn't.
This is a well-known fact.
She doesn't believe in sleep.
Like, sleep when you're dead.
Sleep when you're dead. Dave needs sleep, but I think 1 + 1 = 2 in this case, that the more I don't sleep, the more I get worn down, and old man Dave just is under the weather. So that's where we're at with this. All right, into it. We're going to go over this quickly. We have to quickly address it. Josh, big time tweet. What do you call these things? A tweet stream?
Thread.
Basically. Wow.
That makes it sound like super
intense.
Telling
the world how you feel. We talked about it. Should we even mention it? Because I know you want to get past this. But how are we feeling right now after the whole debacle, I guess, is now a couple weeks old, 3 weeks old, something like that.
Yeah. No, yeah, I'm feeling good. I mean, I'm feeling a lot better. I'm ready to, like, go out a bit, maybe party a bit. Who knows? We'll see what happens.
Okay. So that's good. That's good. I saw the tweet stream. We're going to put that all behind us. Such a weird, hard, because our show is clearly, we like getting, if you were in a different world, if this like drama happened and it wasn't directly affecting you, we'd be like, oh, we got to get these people on and talk.
Yeah, we'd eat it all up.
Yeah, but then when it's actually somebody you know, it's a little bit different. So I'm glad we can put this thing behind us. Everybody goes on their way. I don't know. I'll say best of luck to them, but let's just move on. We'll move past it. How's that?
Perfect.
Yes, sir.
Love it.
Okay.
It's in the past.
We have Whitney Cummings coming on the show. We did this before. Very funny. Gruen versus Bryce. So Gruen ends up in the middle of this thing every time. Gruen pulled Griffin and Josh from the Sway reality show, and Bryce and Gruen went at it. We have a clip. Let's watch the clip.
Yeah, just first things first. It's like, I love how people say he pulled us like we wouldn't have a choice. It was like, we chose not to do the show.
How long had this been going on for?
The show or like the drama?
The show.
The show was like, I think we were probably a part of it for like 5 weeks, maybe like 4 weeks. And then we were like, bro, this is just wrecking so many deals. Like this is getting people like texting us being like, you guys look like idiot. Like, it was just not good. It was the worst idea ever.
And so, did Bryce want to keep doing it?
Yeah, no, all the other boys wanted to keep doing it. They didn't want to stop the reality show. I mean, it was like a fat bag, right? But for us, it was just not worth it.
Okay, so let's see the clip. Speaking of fat bags. That was low blow.
Why are you staring at me like that?
Low blow.
Why are you staring at me?
Because I was asking you a question. It would just be a respectful man thing to do to just tell me.
Big respectful man thing.
We're done.
So stupid.
It got really stressful. We didn't see a significant utility out of the show itself other than cash. Every decision we make, including leaving the show, is a group conversation because ultimately, everything we do personally affects our professional life.
You kicked me out of the venture capital thing too when it's my entire name.
Animals, your name?
Yes.
Oh, I'm sorry. Didn't know animals exist without you.
Animal is my whole brand, dude. Party Animal is my whole brand.
If you think it's like this, then sue me.
Why'd you choose Animal?
I don't know. Why not?
Who gave you the idea of Animal? Here, I'll just answer for you. I did. You on everybody in Sway. Look at your text to Blake.
What, where I called him out for being a jackass with you?
Where you said that you know every single person that he works with for brand deals, and you said you could take him away like
not
that?
What I said.
Like, is that what he said?
Yeah.
I don't have a photographic memory, so I don't remember the exact text, but is it something like that?
Something in that area, yeah.
No.
What kind of power do you have to do that?
It's not power. If I get a call from a brand asking me to vouch for someone, and I know that they're doing stupid, it's very hard for me to get on the phone with someone and say, yes, I vouch for that person.
Who was the one that put their foot down and split up Sway?
Oh, me, 100%.
Hey, Michael, let me see your Bitcoin wallet. Oh, yeah, because you don't have Bitcoin. You're a complete cap. The only reason you're getting connections right now is our likeness. You're messing with the top influencer. I'm delusional. You try to get me out of my own energy drink that has my name on it.
First of all, never try to get you out.
Josh, sorry to involve you.
What's
up?
Did
he try to get me out?
There was a time when you weren't coming on any calls, yeah, for like 4 or 5 years.
You tried to get me out of my own energy drink.
What the f- does that even mean?
Because it was my idea. Literally, nobody speaks up to him. Everybody just gets stepped on by him. And I don't like it. He tries to claim that he has so much power. He says he can ruin anybody. Ruin me. I'm telling him. I'm giving him permission. Like, do it.
Damn.
I can be honest. Okay. I may have to start watching this fucking show if it wasn't canceled. That was pretty fucking good.
That was good. I watched it. Kareem texted me, you got to watch this episode. I watched it, and then I binged the whole thing.
That, to me, felt very real.
I mean, bro, that shit's so fucking fake and, like, cut together in certain ways. That whole entire scene wasn't even shot close to like that. Like, they're editing in stuff that happens, like, 3 hours later, putting it before, and, like, they'll add the stuff that's from, like, 2-day clip interview before, throw it into there. It's, like, it's kind of weird. Super weird.
So Gruen commented on that. He said that the episode initially was supposed to be about Dave, like, and that you broke up today. We have the clip.
Yeah.
It's like a short clip from a podcast that he did with Griffin, but basically it was supposed to be about Dave, and then they just changed it and made it about Gruen.
No, they did. That is true. We got to watch the first, like, aired episode.
This guy, dude.
What actually bothers me more is the personal relationships to this. Like, I consider Bryce a friend. You know, it affects them personally. Yeah. Like, but the other part about it, I think this whole thing is really funny, is they originally filmed an episode where they painted the entire narrative that Dave Portnoy broke up Sway. And then Facebook didn't let them show that because it was, like, already on the internet, all that information. So then the next episode is, like, it's me who broke up Sway. So I texted the executive producer. I'm like, I don't know. I'm just curious. Like, was it Dave or me? Because it keeps changing.
Yeah, like, I just want to know.
They're like, they're like, information evolves. And now some of the guys think it was you. And I said, but they thought yesterday on record that it was Dave. So are you, like, maybe you're creating a narrative? Is it possible? They didn't respond.
Yeah. It's, well, like, I mean, obviously they are. I mean.
Oh, really?
I mean, not wrong. I, like, it was kind of funny because they did show us, like, this they would, like, do these airings, right? And we'd all sit down and watch the episodes before they came out. And there was this whole episode, Dave, where it was, like, me and you were fucking Satan. Like, we were the worst people on the earth. We were the reason Sway broke up. We were, like, the epitome of just bad dudes. And then there was, like, I think Bryce had,
where would they even get the footage of that from me?
It was just, like, from our podcast recording with Bryce. It was, like, a couple, like, clips they were taking off the internet, taking off of Barstool. And then Facebook was like, nah, we can't air this, because there was, like, a bunch of drinking montage clips from, like, Bryce's old vlogs, or, like, strippers from his old vlogs or something crazy like that. So then Facebook was like, we can't air this episode. So then they reshot the entire episode and completely changed the entire narrative.
They had to find a new villain.
How big is this show, or was this show? Is it still going now that you're out of it, or is the show dead?
I mean, I don't know. It's still going. No, it's still being filmed.
But you're just not in it.
No, I just was like, I'm gonna leave, because, like, we didn't want to do it from the start, but then they were like, no, we're gonna cancel the show for all the boys if you and Griff don't do it. And we were like, fuck. Well, that makes us feel like dicks if we're taking away, like, $100,000 deals or hundreds of thousands of dollars from our friends that are already, like, committed to that, right? They already thought they were getting it. They already signed the deal. So it was just, like, this really weird situation where we were kind of like, all right, do we take the hit and do the deal? But then it just started affecting too much stuff, so we had to step
away. So how much money did you turn down, Josh?
I ended up, like, the full deal was, like, half a mil.
For just you or for everybody? Yeah.
No, for me.
Oof. So you just turned that is... You're living right if you just turn that down.
Yeah, wow.
And am I wrong? This is my impression as we continue with Sway. And even though I threw that jab, I like making fun of him. I like Gruen.
Team Gruen. I like
Gruen. Yeah, he's grown on me. But you...
Gruen's grown.
You, Gruen, and Griffin.
Yeah.
You seem like a pod within. now. Am I wrong about that? Are it, like I don't see Gruen in Bryce being like Bryce does his thing, but I don't see him being like a Gruen guy. I really see it being you, Gruen.
At one point, it was me, Bryce, and Gruen though, for like a good 3 months straight. That was like. Because Griff was kind of doing more like just like still doing social media shit. And then me and Bryce were doing like all these investment calls together and we were doing all the like we were doing everything. And then he just kind of stepped away from it. He just didn't like it. He wanted to be more entertainment focused. He started like being like, nah, I don't really want to do that stuff, which is fine. Like, cool. You go do what you want to do. You know what I mean? Bryce is like an entertainer at heart. He's like big energy in front of a camera. He's not like sit down at a desk and listen to a venture call for 30 minutes to an hour. That's not that guy.
Right. So would you say I'm right then in that assessment?
Now, yeah. Now I would say you're right. I would say that it's like me, Griff, and Gruen go and do our work together every day. And then like, we hang out with people. It's just like when we're working, we're together. Usually.
So how's the relationship right now? And I know it's gone up and down with Bryce. Good?
Yeah. No, I would say I'm chilling. Like I would say we're great.
Okay. Interesting. How many views? Do we know how many views that Sway show? That was like, whether it's real or not.
So I know it's on two places. It's on like their Instagram and it's on their Facebook, but we can check.
Okay. Welker, so our BFF hoodies. I don't mind the BFFs being on the shoulder. Just, I guess we send out the hoodies wrong. They're in the center and outside the shoulder.
Who yeah, that's kind of fucking annoying.
There's a thief in the office. They left me my hoodie and someone stole it and we caught them wearing it. And there was only 4 hoodies ever made. And then Owen stole my hoodie.
Owen just stole it?
He just stole it off my desk and is pretending that he didn't steal it from me. He's just wearing it around.
Well, is he still holding on to that narrative, though?
Yeah, he's saying that he took it off Kareem's desk, but he took it off my desk and he's just wearing it around proudly.
Or well, the issue Kareem... was I never had one because they were like prototypes. Like, we had like 4 in existence. Like, I think Dave had 2, Bree had 1, Josh had 1. So he couldn't have taken it.
So did everybody who got it
get
with
a shoulder
logo
piece
on the shoulder as opposed to the center?
They're shipping this week, so we don't know yet. Yeah. I think that person is probably one of the first people. So next week we might have to give an update and say like all 500 or
well, we
however many we
sold. Resend
them
and make Welker pay for them.
Right.
True.
All right. Videos to react to. Logan Paul on Alex Cooper hookup. By the way, how's Griffin's relationship going with the girl that I hooked him up with?
Dude, it was like super like nothing went anywhere.
She's awesome.
Right? Yeah, she was bad. She was good looking.
And cool.
Yeah, super cool. Met her at the pod, no?
Oh, yes, he was correct. Talking to me about her. He said that she is looking for a relationship and he's not looking for a relationship.
Damn. Fair enough.
Yeah.
Hey, at least
everyone's single for the summer.
Singy for the summer?
The opportunity presented itself and like I'm curious. And I was like, yo, she fucking talks the talk. Can she walk the walk?
So you hit the Gluck Gluck 9000.
I didn't hit the Gluck Gluck 9000, George. But one of us did.
Her.
And it was fantastic. And she walks the walk. Like, if there's one, like, icon of this generation who should be giving young women, and even men, sex advice, it's Alex fucking Cooper.
Really?
My issue with it was this. She went on the podcast and said, Logan, quote unquote, Logan Paul can't keep a secret. And in my mind, I'm like, dude, I told like one like close friend.
Yeah.
And you just told the whole internet. I even texted her. I was like, hey, like, are we good? Did this like, did that offend? Was I supposed to like lock that in a vault forever? Like, how can I? That's all, like, I liken it to fucking finding the fountain of youth and not telling anyone.
Yeah.
Like, I got it. I found it. And it was great. I'm sorry for putting your business out here, Alex.
She
like,
started it.
Fuck you. It's like, I'm just going in. She doesn't put out. I think I was, like, a very, like, rare circumstance. Nah, I think I was a very rare circumstance, like, for whatever reason. She doesn't put out. And at first, I was like, oh, she's, like, cap, like, because she definitely doesn't put out. And, yeah, like, She's a creative at heart, and she just happens to be the product.
Same, I'm lost. Same shit as me. Lost just now. Like, Danny's
she's a marketer.
Lost me.
She's smart.
I got to be honest. I keep hearing the word cap. What the fuck does that mean?
Cap means cap? Like you're lying.
Like you're capping. Lying. Like you're lying.
Oh, yeah. And all girls say that. I mean, the I don't put out thing that he said, all girls, like, after they is, oh, I don't put out, whatever. But, yeah, so that's Josie, Harry Josie.
Yeah,
that's
he's the one that spilled it.
He's
yeah.
the one who spilled it. He's, by wow. the way, he's become like a Team Portnoy guy.
Since BFS?
I can't go. He's commenting on everything. He's sending me like voice memos. He's like my boy now.
He's your best friend, dog.
Yeah. I will say I'm like Logan Paul in this sense, except I'm open. Not necessarily hooking up. I don't like being told secrets. If you tell me things, I have to tell people.
You can't keep right. secrets, yeah.
But I'm open about it. Like, don't tell me about it. Just don't, because I will not keep it.
Yeah, no.
You've always been like that? You just can't keep secrets?
Oh, I can't keep a secret. What's the point of knowing something if you can't tell somebody?
I mean, I guess it's true.
It's a better way to go. So if you tell me, I'm telling everybody.
That was like Lana with the last pod. You were just
100%.
Like, why'd you tell me that?
Yeah, she's like, I beep beep, blah, blah, Blake Griffin, blah, blah. Like, well, I have to say something.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, but pissed. We just did. It's all good.
T-Pain doesn't know how Instagram DMs work.
I was today years old when I found out about the requests folder on Instagram that's full of celebs trying to reach me. Dude, is that Fergie?
Hey, Barstool's in there.
SMH. Oh Lord, I missed him here. I've been accidentally straight up ignoring all these people for like 2 years. I thought DMs are supposed to just show up in the normal folder, and you don't have to go digging for all these.
Yeah, it didn't have to go on this long. He was just showing off now.
Yeah, he was showing off for a little bit at the end, but wow.
He's got a lot of people. He was a super nice guy. I met him. I did a pizza review with him. I wore his shades. I remember that. It was like before a concert or something.
That might be the most clouted DM request.
He's got
actually, no. Bill Gates' wife is probably right now is the most clouded DM request
with the breakup.
Yeah,
Dave, you know how many people must be sliding. You didn't know that was a thing. Remember Dobrik?
The top. Mine though, I don't have a lot of people in there like that. I had like three people, but Dixie and Noah Beck take Disneyland. By the way, Dixie's very close. I want people to cut this to get on my shit list because I went on her show. She's supposed to go on ours, and now her people have been sort of like big time in us. She's always like, yeah. And then her people like, oh, she can do it at the end of May. It's 20 minutes, Dixie. I went to LA. I did your fucking show. So before this turns into World War III, I would tell your people, cut out 20 minutes and come on the show because that was the deal we made.
You don't want World War III.
No.
You don't want it.
Dixie and Noah Beck take Disneyland.
All right. I mean, this probably looks like World War III.
Oh, hey, Dixie and Noah.
Hey, Disney Parks TikTok.
While we have you here, we just have to know, what is your favorite Disney Parks snack?
Mine's probably the spicy pickle.
Mine's got to be the Frosty Parfait.
No cap. See you real soon.
Did they just say no cap?
I mean, that was they shouldn't have said no cap. It didn't even make sense in that situation.
Everybody's saying no cap, everybody's saying now. And if you're saying it now, you're too late on Instagram. Last night was a movie. Enough of that. Everywhere you go, tonight's going to be a movie. Last night was a movie. Enough. That has already come and gone.
Yeah.
Like
you in the basement with your boys isn't a movie, bro.
Everything last night was a movie.
Brianna with her post yesterday.
Noah Beck.
Brianna posted that yesterday. We're not skipping this. Brianna posted a TikTok, and it was very My Life's a Movie.
Did you?
But I did not write My Life's a Movie, though. I posted I posted a montage of my day.
My day was a movie.
The caption was like,
I was like very happy because I saw my boyfriend for the first time in a while.
I thought you broke up with him.
No, we're together.
Me too.
Again.
So you did break up and you're back together.
We were having a little rough patch and we were together. Yeah.
But they're stronger than ever, she said. That's good, right?
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Yeah. Me and Dave, he's got a girl now too. So you guys, you're single for the summer and now we're coupled up.
Gosh, you guys are leaving the third BFF just to fucking go and into the trenches all alone.
Noah Beck.
Yeah.
Wearing Mickey Mouse ears, getting dragged around Disney World on a leash.
It's the worst, man. Come on, Noah. Like, let's go play some soccer.
He's wearing Mickey Mouse ears. Come on, Noah.
Yeah.
I wonder how much I got paid for that.
Probably infinity dollars.
Yeah, like ridiculous amount of money for that one TikTok.
No cap.
And my last night was a movie. Haven't you guys noticed last night was a movie? It's everywhere. Everybody's saying last night was a movie.
Yeah, it's because everyone's out of COVID now, or like they're starting to get out a little bit. So then they're going out and like partying or whatever, and they're like, last night was a movie, dog. Like, we went out and we had like 4 beers each. It was wild. Everyone's tolerances are low. Everything's just going to go crazy, man.
Do we want to do this? Siblings or dating? Do we want to do the game or no?
We can save it. We have a couple of headlines we skipped.
Where are the headlines? I skipped headlines?
Yeah. Which page?
What?
Oh, shoot. That is true.
All right, roll back. Activewear. I'm wearing it right now. Bring out the baby blues. Guys over at Robeck have been sending us some of their performance tees, polos, hoodies. I love their stuff. I didn't even know I was going to be wearing it for the show. I was naturally wearing it. Their performance tees, hands down, some of the best performance tees in the game. The fabric's so freaking soft for a performance tee lined with silver technology to prevent odor. You may recognize the subtle dog logo right there. Or the two stripes on the back of their shirts. Gear is pumping up all over the place, which is saying something. Robeck's performance polos are next level. Fabric is so comfortable, stretchy, you won't want to take them off. Do yourself a favor. Go check out their Instagram at Robeck, R-H-O-B-A-C-K, or just straight up visit their website, Robeck.com. Use the code Josh, that's Josh's name, obviously, 20% off your first purchase through the end of the week. That's spelled Robeck.com. 20% off all performance tees, Q-zips, hoodies with code Josh. Go check them out at Robeck.com. All right, then we'll do the headlines. Little Huddy new music video is America's Sweetheart, starring Charlie. Yeah. Are they back together?
I don't know. I think they're just besties.
That's what we I don't.
How can you go from dating to besties? That doesn't happen.
Yeah, I'm just going to vouch on that one. Does not happen.
Okay, so let's see it.
I feel so alone in a crowded place. Every conversation feels so fake. Everything I touch always seems to break. I get so depressed when I hear your name. Oh, I don't really give a shit if you stay. I don't really give a shit if you go. I don't really give a shit either way. Either way, I feel alone. I don't really give a shit if you stay. I don't really give a shit if you go.
Is that Charlie dancing?
I don't really give a shit either way. Either way, I feel alone.
We're about to get hella copyright. We just made Chase
this
a bag
stinks.
Off this pod.
You don't like it?
This song sucks.
I thought you liked Little Huddy.
I'm neutral on Little Huddy, but that song's no good.
Oh, see, I kind of like it.
I was waiting for the chorus the entire time.
Well, you didn't hear it yet, I don't think.
All right, let me get to the chorus before I judge.
Yeah, that's true. You can't judge before the chorus.
If you love me,
wait. Maybe the give a shit part was the chorus?
Kind of like the one down
things coming. We're about to drop.
And I'm gonna tell you something you don't wanna hear. I won't feel good until I disappear. Oh, I don't really give a shit if you stay.
Yeah, they give a shit.
I don't like it.
That shit was the chorus.
That song is too slow. That song is too boring, too slow. If that was an American Idol song, I'd tell the contestant, pick a new song. Okay. Too slow.
It's slow, but I think that's like what he was going for because she was all dancing.
Yeah, definitely was
contemporary.
Going for those.
Don't like that song.
Look at the views.
Mm. I don't doubt it. Little Huddy puts asses in the seats. I don't doubt that.
Right. And,
Little Huddy
and you're telling me,
D'Amelio,
you're telling me Lil
Huddy,
yeah,
going to get a
combo?
Million views.
You like his other, but you liked his other song, right? The vampire one? 21st century vampire. I think we reacted to it and you were head on.
Maybe. But they're definitely together again if they're in the video.
Yeah.
They're not just friends.
Randy, right?
Yeah, I think they're back together.
Huddy stands come after Bryce Josh for old real music take. What does this mean?
Old real music. Oh my God. I think it's because. What was it? Hit us up. This is so.
You drop into this track.
I actually want to do real music.
Oh shit. Oh my god.
And it hit me when your real music gets 4 million views in 4 days.
Oh, man,
that shit was funny as fuck. I mean, he still doesn't have a video with like what 100 million total streams across platforms, but it's fine.
That's still whatever. Softish.
Yes, sir.
Still softish.
Ah, no, I'm kidding. Congrats to him. I think that song, like, his voice sounds like it improved from the last one. It sounds like there was like...
Well, he wasn't auto-tuned on that one.
Yeah, there was a less auto-tune. There was a couple points, but like he was softer singing, you know? So you got a little bit more to hear that like actual voice, I think.
So he always dressed like that, even was when he was with you guys.
Yeah.
He was the original E-boy.
Well, yeah, he was like the OG, like...
Nail painted.
Can I see that hoodie he was wearing again?
It was like deadly. You didn't want to sit too. We couldn't sit too close. I'm on the couch because he was like poking my eye out at one point.
He had spikes coming out of his eye.
You see how far away we had to be? Yeah.
Damn.
It got me in the eye.
Was Huddy part of what? Like, was he in Sway ever?
No.
Hype House.
No. We were. He was in Hype House, and then like it was like. We were both in Lights Out Boys, which was like our tour that we went on. We were in that group, and that's when we were like homies.
Got it. All right. Yeah. Charlie gives her fans a name, Charlie DeMeo. A lot of Charlie news.
Jeez.
She turned 17.
What do you guys think?
Charlie
before
is
we watch
17
this?
Years old.
She just turned 17.
She's 17.
This week.
She's 1'7".
1'7".
That is a young motherfucker.
She's got the world ahead of her.
Holy shit. Charlie's only 17?
Kind of blew my mind.
How old is Huddy?
How old is Huddy? 19?
Huddy turns 19 in 10 days.
Oh, yeah. Jeez.
Holy
so they're like 2
shit.
Years. That's not even bad.
I mean, Charlie's like the youngest. That's crazy.
I sometimes forget doing the show how young you guys
that's
are.
That's crazy,
like
bro.
Sperm.
No cap.
Yeah.
No cap.
Still being
no
fertilized.
You're so young. So young and rich.
And I don't think that it's cool to be making fun of the people that give me the platform that I have. I think my... Baby Duncans are the cutest people on planet Earth, and I really don't like you guys making fun of them, so please don't do that. It's really hurtful, and they have feelings too, so can we please stop that? Because I'm going to stop using this account if that's what my comments are filled with.
People were making fun of the baby Duncans.
That's her fans?
Yeah, the baby Duncans. Yes.
For how long has that been her fans?
Probably since she got the Duncan deal. Gaz loves that clip. He told me about it like 4 times, like we got to play the baby Duncans clip.
Why do you like that?
It is an awesome clip.
Have the baby Duncans bought into it?
You know what? It's kind of baller just to be able to like label your fans.
You just
it's like
name
like
your
cult. She's running
not
a cult.
Only that, she named him after
she's
an advertiser.
Yeah.
Dunkin' Donuts.
She literally
like,
used
hey.
Her.
She owns.
She used
Dunkin'
her fans
Donuts.
To make a brand deal. She used their name. She was like, "Hey, watch this shit real quick. I'm gonna make a bag off my fans' names.
Yeah,
baby
give
Duncans.
Me $10 Boom. Billion dollars, and we're gonna name my fans the Baby Dunks. Unbelievable.
If Charlie didn't." Get a brand deal out of that.
She already
she
had it.
New
she's already
team.
Sponsored
she
by Dunkin's. It just probably
agent,
ticked,
she needs
like increased it. This 17-year-old
there has to be a
like
bonus.
Chess when everyone's playing checkers. It's crazy,
right? God damn,
baby Dunkin's.
Baby Dunkin's.
Is there something
I'm about to come out with a new fan name called like the, I don't know, adult Starbs or something like that. That sounds weird, but
what do we call BFF stands? Besties. I feel like besties is
besties?
Just.
I think. We would lose 50% of our
do
audience.
Do we have any stands?
If
I don't even know.
Like
the Twitter is insane. Like, I do all the tweeting, and it's like you post, and then within like 10 seconds, like people have the notifications on, hundreds of people.
How many people are on our Twitter account?
I think it has like 35,000 followers, but that's not really a good metric. But like, we can tweet anything, and it explodes.
I get tagged in like at least 20 videos a day of people making videos about us three.
Really?
That stan us pretty hard.
Wow. They do. They're standing all over us.
All right. Good. Jeff Wittick broke his face doing stunt for David Dobrik video. So Dobrik's still out here just doing shit?
No. This is called the Vlog Squad is now realizing David is gone. They have nothing left to make like money. Mm-hmm. And now he's like, let me go on this rampage where I'm going to like come up with a documentary, come up with all this shit and just like pile up the views, get as much money as I can while I still got clout. That's what I feel like. Because it seems like everyone that knows him is just like, they're just piling on the outing. Like, they're just piling and piling and piling it on. So I feel like this is just like, we got nothing left. Bunch of chickens running with their heads cut off.
Yeah, I feel like Jeff Wittick is also milking the shit out of this, though. It could have been like one YouTube video, and he's acting like it was something.
He made a whole documentary, no?
Yeah.
I don't know, like, the full situation, what happened. What I heard, and I heard this, like, actually before it even came out. I heard this, like, 5 months ago when David, like, stopped his vlogging. Like, his whole break from vlogging was essentially because this, actually, not COVID, I heard. But they were training for a skydiving or, like, some stunt, and Jeff was training for it. Mm-hmm. And then for that stunt, he was, like, tied to a excavator. And they were swinging him around on a lake, and David's, like, filming it with one hand while swinging him around on the excavator, and just went too quick, flung him into, like, a...
I mean, he did almost die, yeah.
Yeah, which is, like, brutal. And apparently, like, David never even went and visited him in the hospital, something like that. Like, never cared, never came to see him. Went with him to the hospital when he was hurt, but then, like, never visited him again, never talked about it. But, I mean... Maybe it was just like they never established the line between, like, are they homies or is this a business, you know?
Let's see the video.
Corinna gets on it and then David starts moving it. It's like, this shot looks so sick. This looks beautiful.
God damn.
The thing comes off and it starts falling down, and Corinna's like, oh, what the fuck? Put me down, put me down. She's like, you take things too far, David.
I just jumped out of a plane 20 times. What's the worst that could happen if I swing from a rope over a 1 foot deep lake? And yeah, I didn't know I was gonna go that fast. So I grabbed the fucking rope and I tried to make a goddamn funny video for people. But this is where I made a mistake. I forgot that the biggest fucking idiot I know was driving it.
Oh shit. Oh shit.
Literally a horror movie. That's a horror movie.
Time literally slows down.
Go to Utah Valley Hospital. Just been hurt.
The whole side of his face is just open.
And nobody could do anything to stop it.
Wait a sec. They're all in on this shit?
Yeah, you're right. That felt like that was made for a video.
Yeah. Also, they're acting like David made him, like, do all this stuff. They, like, enabled David. Like, they did all these stunts for him.
What do you mean by they're in on this, Josh?
The documentary.
What the documentary? Why is, like, if Jeff hates this man, why is he going and getting documentary clips from David?
Have you watched it? I watched the documentary.
Not at all.
Jeff's take is kind of like, it was his fault. He did it. He's not mad at David, but he thinks David takes advantage of people. So they're kind of like coming out being like, David's a shitty person, but, like, this wasn't really his fault. We all did this shit with him.
Well, yeah, they realized what they were getting out of it.
Yeah.
They were doing it because clout and money and whatever, but it's just like, God damn. So wait, are, like, David and all these people actually in the documentary?
Yeah, for some parts, but I think there's more coming out. Right now it's really just Jeff, but Natalie talks in it, and so does Jason Nash.
I don't know who any of these people are.
The Vlog Squad. They were, like, the biggest people on the internet.
Yeah.
Like, now it's TikTokers. It was the Vlog Squad.
Got it.
I feel like I need to educate myself before I speak about it because someone's going to, like, take what I say and say, like, I don't know. Like,
no, you didn't say anything wrong about it. You were kind of right.
Weird situation.
I mean, from an outsider without knowing any, Dobrik was huge. I don't know who any of these other people are. They're doing shit with Dobrik so they get huge and make a living. So he puts you on an excavator, slings you across the ocean, your face busts open, get a couple views. You know the game.
Yeah.
What's this no different than fucking Jackass? Like, yeah, you know the game. You're going in, you get shot out of a cannon and into a fucking brick wall, and Uncle Vito comes running out, and hey, that's a wrap. You get views. What's the difference here? Don't complain your face gets ripped apart. You want to have clout. You want to be part of the Vlog Squad. You want the shine. You get thrown around an excavator.
Yeah.
Big deal.
That's what I'm saying. They did it. It's not like David made them do it.
You almost died. Big deal, dog.
You want clout? You want people to know who you are? Like, would people know who you are if you're just walking on the street, punching a clock 9 to 5? No. So shut up and get thrown off an escalator.
Off an escalator.
Yeah.
Everyone's just, we're going to have, like, a mass report from kids just jumping off of escalators and malls now.
Trying to get off, get on BFS.
Yeah, trying to get views.
I think that's it, right?
Yeah, that's it. Unless you guys want questions, but.
We can do questions.
Yeah, let's run some questions.
Okay. All right. Who was your first celebrity crush that you can remember?
Kristen Kruk, Smallville.
Selena Gomez.
Okay, good. Who's Kristen Kruk?
Woo! Fire.
Yeah, that's a good question.
She's on a show, Smallville. She was so hot. So hot.
First crush
remember,
ever?
You remember Topanga from Blaine's
World? Yeah, Punky Brewster. Super little. I like Punky Brewster, too.
Hmm. Okay. Topanga, what's a relationship deal breaker for you?
Relationship deal breaker?
Cigarettes. Mm. Smoking cigarettes, 100%. Maybe not going cigarettes. To sleep.
Okay. I have a funny answer, but I don't know if I have room.
I mean, you can't just dangle us like that.
Yeah, you could give us two answers if you need to.
I don't know what's a deal. Like, is it like rude? Do you think it's rude to say like bad breath?
No, that's a fucking
deal breaker. No, that's a huge deal breaker, I would say so.
I just don't want to be like a rude guy. Yeah.
Bad breath, you cannot overcome bad breath. But right. Someone has it's bad like, breath and you can't, that's absolutely a deal breaker.
Deal breaker. Okay.
Get that out of my face.
What advice would you give your younger self right now if you could talk to them?
Keep your circle tight as fuck.
I think that had some bearing in reality. younger self.
That was such a like
dramatic like villain.
Yeah.
Pause.
Wow.
I don't know. I really don't know. Younger self, younger Dave was just not doing much. I mean, he was just kind of living. I don't know. I really don't know.
No advice? No regrets?
No, I really don't. I don't know.
Yeah, younger fuck self, regrets, no. Dog.
I don't have anything. It's a terrible answer, but I don't have. Yeah, don't worry about too much. Every day is different. I don't know.
Yes, okay, sir. Just go with the flow. Go with the flow.
That's great advice always, I think.
Yeah,
that's it for the questions.
All right.
One final thing. Our producers want Josh to react to this video. Remember last week we watched the Hot Boy Summer of him and Bryce? They were like standing in front flexing.
Is it Singy for the Summer?
Yeah. Oh, of Sass.
I love this video, dog. I love this video.
Oh, let's fucking go. The boys are Singy for the Summer? No, trouble is coming. No, sir.
I absolutely love that video. I saw that, and I think I sent that to like five people.
Little sass.
It was funny too because like I knew like bro, I went over to the house and I knew Bryce was gonna want to film that video. Like I knew he was gonna want to get that type of video because like we both just went through the breakup, so I knew he was gonna want to do it. And I'm like in the bathroom and I'm like changing and I hear Bryce come up and he's like, "Hey Josh, you want to film a TikTok, man?" And I'm like, oh, "Yeah, sure. Just give me a sec." And I'm like waiting for Griff to get done his thing because then we were gonna leave after. And I'm like, I was in there for like 5 minutes. I'm trying to like act like it's just taking me a long time to put my pants on or something. And then Griff is just taking so long. And I'm just like, fuck, all right, we'll film it. I don't really care that much. We went and we filmed the video, did the little like daps up or whatever. It was kind of funny, but it was just also like kind of, you know.
It's kind of sway boy. Prime yeah. Sway Boy House.
Sure. Prime Sway. Yeah, that's a great word for it. Prime Sway Boy.
Yeah, it was Sway.
Yeah.
Most guys have tried different ways to last longer, but thinking about baseball always doesn't always work. Folks at Roman, an online men's health company, changed the game with Roman Swipes, a secret to long-lasting sex or longer-lasting sex. Can't get bad with that. Saying the Pledge of Allegiance in your head, counting backwards from 10, doesn't work. Roman Swipes works. Clinically proven to last longer in bed. Effective, easy to use, fast acting. Don't require prescription. Go to getroman.com/BFF. Get your first month of Swipes for just $5 when you choose a monthly plan. That's getroman.com/BFF. Make your sex last longer. That's good for everybody. Just swipe them. See them holding. Fit in your wallet, too. So go to Roman. GetRoman.com/BFF. First month of Swipes for just $5 when you choose a monthly plan. GetRoman.com/BFF.
Okay, so BFFs, we're already... Whitney Cummings, thank you for coming. And I know it's a big deal because we asked you short notice.
Yeah, no, I'm only here for the money that you're paying me.
And by the way, you said that. Does any podcast pay for
this? I do. Yeah, I pay for car service, hair, makeup, and then I donate.
Donate what?
Money. I just say, like, what charity of your choice, I'll donate.
Okay, so you said you have a podcast today with Kevin Nealon, right?
I do, yeah.
Okay, so how much do you pay for that?
I will provide him a car, hair and makeup if he wants it.
But we offered you a car.
Oh, really? That's fine. I drove myself.
Okay.
Yeah.
I didn't know.
I know women can't drive, and you probably think women.
No, I don't think that.
I did okay.
I don't think that. I don't think that at all. I think women can drive just as equally as men. So,
just as equally.
Yeah. And by the way, we had a big list of guests.
Yeah.
And there was probably what?
I know. I literally was like, who canceled last minute?
Which is something I would say. So yeah. I like that. But you were on the extreme short list of who I picked. I don't
know.
Josh.
That's true. You have
Josh has never heard of me. So
well,
he thinks I'm Joan Rivers. He doesn't even know who that is.
He's younger. He's clearly younger.
He thinks I'm Stormy Daniels. He's like, who is this?
No, I don't think that is.
Yeah.
Where have you ever heard of me? I saw you just furiously reading my tweets right as I sat down, trying to figure out who I was.
That is what I was
actually
doing.
Thanks for preparing.
Doing.
Printout. Someone printed that. So someone,
two broke girls.
Someone
I know
printed
that.
Out. Someone That's killed a tree so that you could look at my tweets, even though your phone is right there where you could have looked at my tweets.
Well, that I feel like to his defense, to accumulate the tweets in that order.
I feel like he can defend himself. Why don't you let him defend himself?
Go for it.
I mean, I don't really. Why do I need to defend myself for reading a one sheet? I feel like it's like Reddit. No,
I'm excited to be here. I'm sort of fascinated by you.
Yeah, well, you said that's what I was going to ask. I couldn't tell. I thought you were joking. First of all, I don't know. Mike Gruen.
Yeah.
So you're friends with him?
No. I mean, I'm fascinated by the fact that he's going to go to jail any minute, and no one is saying anything.
Because
I
walk of, like, in the Lou house. Pearlman, you
well,
mean?
Well, no. I mean, his pants are around his ankles. His pants are. I walk in a home. You know that Louis C.K. has not worked since because of that exact thing.
Oh, you're saying he did that to you?
No, I'm just saying you can't walk around with your pants around your ankles anymore when you have people around and you're doing a production.
That's physique.
Have you guys not learned anything from my generation?
That's
but
his
like
physique,
though.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I mean, like some.
Well, no, he's gonna have a heart attack in 20 minutes. I mean, so I just wanted to sort of get it on the ground floor.
I like how you go right after.
I've told him that.
Yeah.
I said like, yo, get. I bought him a Bowflex. Uh-huh. I was like, yo, get on the bike.
Yeah.
He didn't.
So I was confused by our text exchange. So what we did, I was like, yeah, I think you're very funny.
Thank you.
Who else did we pick on that? It was Snoop, you, and.
That was like it.
There was one more person, maybe. But
thank
I can't.
You.
TikTok.
Mark Wahlberg, maybe.
Mark Wahlberg.
And we were like he, craziest. No offense, he's just the name there. I wasn't sure he'd get what we were doing, but so it was a very short
only
list.
Person with people with dumber names of their posse than you, Spider, over here.
Spider's actually a great
Spider, what's
name.
Your actual name? Daniel.
How did it
I'm gonna
happen,
call you
Spider.
Daniel.
Why did you get that nickname? Well, Spider got his job by saying
you know
busy.
His real name, though?
Dan DiOrio, yes. Okay. He got his job by, he would just carry water.
Do you know his name?
Yeah, Kareem.
Okay. His name?
Now, we had a little, do you ever watch 24-7, no, 24, right? The show?
The show?
Did you ever watch that?
Yeah, it's a hot reference.
Yes. Well, I have great references. So, he had a gambling syndicate within our office, basically. Ah. And I nicknamed him Marwan, and that got a little bit, we had to change that because everyone's like, wait, did you say it because? Because
you're kind of the new Steve Jobs. Remember when Steve Jobs had two. Oh,
that's nice.
Yeah,
that's
no, I'm a nice person.
I think I was waiting to figure out like.
Yeah, that's huge.
You are. I mean, people thought he was an asshole.
I was waiting to figure out what the insult is.
No, I'm not insulting you at all. I'm a fan.
That was a day.
But here's the thing, comics fuck around. Like comics fuck around. And when you have comics, this is what I called my girl last night. I was like, do you know what you're signing up for? Comedians come on and we fuck around and we're sarcastic and we like.
But that's.
Barb.
That's me.
Okay, good.
Yeah, so I can. So okay. Back to the text exchange.
Let me finish my thing about Steve Jobs. So he had two employees named like Joe or something and didn't have time to like figure out which was which. So he's like, your name's Billy now. Like he just changed their names.
we all have kind of nicknames that work. Like I guess Kareem doesn't, but Spider just stuck. He used to carry just water. Like the key to getting hired is just for us is just act busy. So Spider literally would carry
like
the water from one side of the office, put it down, pick it up and carry it back and forth.
Yeah. Genius.
I was like, oh, Spider's
Genius.
Killing it.
So, that is so smart.
Now, look
he ended up, now he's here.
Yeah.
I respect that.
The text exchange.
Yes.
I thought it was joking, and then you were like,
joking.
So you didn't think we were gonna attack you, or like what was it?
Ambush.
Oh no. Well, for me, the way that this I'm learning about how the podcast space works. I've only recently been doing a podcast for the past like year or so, and it's just it's such a casual vibe. It's like, hey, want to do my podcast tomorrow at noon? It's just sort of like
very casual.
I don't normally like book things like 12 hours in advance, but I did it.
So we're never together. This was kind of like a last minute us getting out here. And
yeah.
It's always better
it's
when
awesome.
You do it in Zoom. But yeah, so.
I kind of like to prepare and know what I'm doing, but I'm not prepared. And so
how
we'll
do you prepare
for a podcast?
For like just a casual conversation.
Yeah, well, in my day, you show up, you know something about the guest, you've heard of them, you've Googled them in advance, you sort of walk.
Oh, no, I like typed your name in Google.
Oh, thank you, thank you.
I gave you that like honor. I was not disrespectful.
Like, I can't know who you are or else I would go to jail. Like, I would be on Megan's
list. Right.
Like, I can't follow you on social media. My friends, my male friends have done that with young females and they aren't working. So I can't really know your work.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Or else I'm a pedophile.
True. Perfect.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. How old are you?
You're 19 now, right?
Yeah.
All right, I'll follow you. Okay, I can follow you now. Okay,
good. We're out of the pervert, like, age.
You're allowed to know who I am. I'm not really allowed to know who you are. Right. There's, like, laws around this stuff.
Well, 18, yeah, and you've been in, you were in the middle of that with a lot of your people.
What's the legal age in Canada for, is there a, I just don't know.
18, is it?
I'm looking for a.
Yeah, like, what do you, like, age of consent?
Oh, you mean
yeah.
Have sex?
Yeah.
I think it's 16.
Is it in Canada?
Yeah,
it is because that, so I went to school in Michigan, like go right over the board. Do we have, you'd like the game we play actually. No, so because the age difference, we do Boomer Zoomer and we put up, like they didn't know who like Pearl Jam was, for example.
Yep.
And then I won't know basically anybody they're doing. You're 38?
I'm 38.
Research,
yeah.
Good job by me.
Yeah, so, thank you.
That would be right up the alley.
By the crow's feet around my eyes, you just looked at my face, 38.
So. You, a lot of what we're seeing there, you think Hollywood's dead? Is that it?
I don't think Hollywood's dead. I think what happens with, like, everything.
By the way, the hair is bold for
Thank
38.
Thank you. Thanks.
Like, people chirp me for being like, you chirp me, like, you know, you're not 18, but you dress kind of like how I dress.
So, do you.
You guys each have a bomber jacket, too.
You do, right now.
Do you want me to answer any of the questions, or do we just.
At your
you ask a question?
Sometimes we just jump over.
Yeah,
your leisure.
It does happen.
So, is the idea to answer the questions you ask, or just to keep jumping around?
Sometimes.
So, I feel like I can dress like this. You guys just dressing in pajamas is.
I'm not in pajamas.
No, that's. Wildly insulting.
That's actually. I just.
Like I know, but, like, in my day, if I, like, was 19 and did a podcast with someone who's, like, achieved. I would like wear like a button down. I would sort of like brush. I would dry my hair.
Are you
hair,
saying
I'd
to be with
it.
Me or you?
No, this is it's washed. That's
it's
why
washed.
It's wet.
Yeah. I mean, it looks like shit.
I would say it's like.
It's like, I can't tell if it's wet or if
seven,
that's pomade.
7.3.
I mean, it looks
that's,
insane. You look
that's
insane.
That's the move though. That's
right.
Like
but that's
what,
the thing.
That's what plays.
But in well, 10 years, are
like
you
drying.
Gonna look back? In 10 years, you're gonna look back and be like, yeah, I nailed that.
I would say so.
Like, do you have a plan for 10 years? Because getting famous this young has worked out for literally no one. Name one person.
Every child Disney star, it has worked out perfectly for them.
Okay, Amanda Bynes, Lindsay
Perfect.
Lohan.
Yeah.
Does that, the name Eddie Furlong mean anything
no.
to you? Macaulay Culkin, Corey Haim, Corey Feldman.
Macaulay Culkin's not doing that.
Macaulay Culkin?
Yeah,
You don't even know how to pronounce his name. He's not doing great.
I struggle.
If David Portnoy doesn't know who he is, he's not doing
No,
well.
I know exactly who it is. I went to it. He's in a pizza band.
I'm just curious. That is true. His brother's killing it on Succession.
Yeah, that's the best
so
show.
So your brother is going to kill it in like 15 years. Do you have a
who
brother?
Who is a child star who's
younger made brother?
Who is a child star who has not gone crazy? Gone to jail, died of it. Like, is there
that,
any
that one?
The Full House. Miley Cyrus is a fair example.
Miley Cyrus has
well.
Fucking nailed it. However, her dad was really famous, and she wasn't really living in Hollywood in a fucking douchey house like this. she was living in
douchey.
Nashville.
I'm
just saying, are you gonna be okay? Billie Eilish, I feel like, is doing great.
Well, she's brand new.
She's brand new and she's young.
Jessica Simpson.
I think
that's
I'm
right.
Fine.
It was a rocky road.
But she's a pretty normal
You're right.
life right now.
But she also started doing the branding stuff and the, you know what I'm saying? She stopped being sort of the face of her business and started branding. So that's what you'll do.
I got it. Olsen twins.
Yeah, that's a fair one.
Aren't they like billionaires?
I mean, like,
people?
Still successful, mentally well.
They're not mentally well?
I don't know. They're wildly successful. They're wildly successful. That's a great one.
Yeah.
How about the other
mentally
one from
happy?
Full House,
I can't.
Though?
I don't know.
Not the Stephanie or whatever from Full House. But
do you know
the
Full
other,
House?
The Full House. I think I've had issues.
I watched Full House, Different Strokes, Fresh Prince of Bel-Air was my favorite show.
But oh, nice.
Yeah.
So,
my parents would like throw me a little bit.
Oh, Will Smith.
Boy Meets World.
Right.
Will Smith was a little bit Topanga. She was in the news. Do you think that's fake?
Dude, I am so cancel that motherfucker, dude.
You think it's fake?
Who?
I don't think it's fake. I just think
the
anyone.
Sure, the center's trust.
Any bitch who is going to come after General Mills, who has provided us joy for 40 years, the product is $3. It's easily.
Is this the shrimp thing?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. But we were talking about last night.
Fucking
we think
dork.
It's fake. think it's a work.
Because he's putting out a Netflix show now. So it's like perfect
it's
way
very
to come out.
Yeah, he's been at Hollywood Tool for a while, that guy.
How'd he get Topanga?
Because actresses are known for their wildly high self-esteem and great choices with
Topanga
men.
Topanga has, I feel like, he doesn't strike me as like a high self.
He's like a Hollywood producer.
I used to have the fattest crush on her.
Yeah, she's awesome.
I was telling this last night. We did a party with her back in the day.
Yeah.
And I was just fat and kind of out of shape at the time. And there's a website, Hot Chicks with Douchebags. And
I remember that site.
It was.
I love that website.
Muscle heads, tan. Yeah. And I took a picture with her, and they just put me a set, and I was wearing a brown.
Oh,
polo.
You were in it. Oh.
It said, Topanga with a potato.
Oh, shit.
That was like the caption.
Now she looks back and is like, oh, wish I had fucking gotten a ring from that guy.
Well, it sounds like she's doing pretty good with
no,
that,
I don't
too.
Think so. No, I think that he tried to come for General Mills, and then, like, girls in Hollywood were like, oh, hell no. Because he tried to come for General Mills. You don't come after cereal.
That is a weird thing.
Easily greatest cereal of all time.
Best breakfast choice.
What? That Cinnamon Toast Crunch?
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm not. I don't fuck with cinnamon.
Oh, really? What do you fuck with?
That's my top
for
three.
For junk cereal?
Yeah.
Well, Cookie Crisp, but it's not even really.
Oh, that is so basic. Yeah. Apple Jacks, maybe.
I like Apple Jacks. Cookie Crisp is basic. How do you not fire
you
back,
cookie,
by the
you
way?
You eat Cookie Crisp. That's why you also hang out with 19-year-olds. We need to work on your.
This is a podcast.
You should be eating Raisin
All right,
Bran.
You're here for the
you
same.
You need grape nuts.
You are
you're
here.
You're 44.
You're here for the same reason.
You need to get
like
a colonoscopy like this afternoon.
I have all the ammo. I'm used to getting attacked by people. You're in my demo. You're my,
You guys can go to the
whatever's rubber.
Together.
What is that old thing? You're rubber. I'm rubber. You're glue. Everything you say bounces off me, sticks to you. Like, all my insults can go right back at you.
What? That was, oh no. That was like a Gilbert Godfrey.
The rubber glue?
I know.
Well, it's like you're hitting me even this. It's like you're dressed
No, you just did like an Andrew Dice Clay set. You're rubber.
I think that's a compliment.
It is.
I'll take that as a compliment.
Of your fans will get that.
The Andrew Dice Clay?
Mm-hmm,
no, we've had, so I'm 44, so our
your
audience.
Stool is old audience.
Yeah,
I've been doing this for 20 years.
Yeah,
so
I know.
They start with me mid, how do you do know?
I do know you, I'm really impressed by you.
You said that I was, what was the word you used? Reckless.
Yeah, I like that, you're dangerous.
What? How so?
I like that about you. Well, most people that like, are forward facing of businesses and stuff. They like play it safe and they're careful and they don't want to offend advertise. Like you're just very reckless and dangerous. And I like that about you. I mean, you're going to get canceled any minute, but
they tried to cancel me already.
You're kind of one of these uncancelable guys because it's just like, you're so reckless, and I mean in a good way. I agree with most of what you say, from what I know. I don't know everything, but I like it about you.
It's kind of like the cancel myself mentality, so how do you cancel me?
Well,
you just are like, this is me.
Well, there's definitely jokes I've made that you can't make now, or they're under way more scrutiny, and I wouldn't have made, but.
But I like that you're a businessman that is like, I'm gonna have a bunch of incendiary opinions and it's not gonna affect my business, it's actually gonna build it. So that's Comedians 101.
Yes, and it was built without the thought of doing that. It was just a very, like, our crowd knew who I was and continue to. The people who don't like me come from the clouds. Like, for example, during Black Lives Matter, I got canceled for something, or tried
Which, by the way, you didn't get canceled.
No, we're here.
You're all here.
But
you're
it was something,
canceled,
there was a big hubla, and I truly, truly didn't, like, I wouldn't, basically, I don't know if, do you know the story of what got me in trouble?
No.
So here's the story. We do Super Bowl parties.
Yes.
And she walks off after this story.
No, I
I can't be sitting
again,
next
I,
to him.
I would
Are
never,
you okay?
I would never do this
I cancel
again.
Her. She has her whole life ahead of her.
I would never do this again, but I did it in real time, and
Real time with Bill Maher?
No, not with Bill Maher. I did this, I made a video. So we do Super Bowl parties every year, and we can't get like Justin Bieber and Taylor Swift, so we have to be creative. So we went old school.
By the way, you could if you paid them, you probably could.
That's.
They are like, you can get people.
Well,
like
you can
that.
Do anything if you have the money.
If you have money.
Like I could go to the moon with Elon Musk
if
totally,
I had the
money. Totally. We don't have the money.
Right.
So ergo, we can't. So we went old school, Ja Rule and Ashanti. Mm-hmm. Best concert ever.
Right.
To announce it, and we do this every year. I face the camera, I'm like, I'm gonna sing his top five songs, you guys guess who it is.
Yeah.
One of his top five songs has the N-word in it, I sang the lyric. They went back 5 years, found it, and my thing was like, I would never do it again, but I'm not that dumb. Like, I knew it was going out to the internet.
Yeah.
I didn't mean intent,
and
for that's where it gets like, so weird now on what you say. So there's instances like that, probably 10 of them, but I always trust my intent, and it's like,
Yeah, intention and impact. And it's also like, I think a lot of people forget. And like, I mean, please correct me if I'm wrong about this. It's, what is it? 22% of people are on Twitter. Of that, 2% generate 80% of the comments.
Right.
So anyone who's really taking Twitter feedback seriously,
it's
like,
an echo chamber.
Like, but also you're the, like, I mean, with comedians and cancel culture, like, we're the ones exacerbating it because we won't stop talking about
it. True.
Stop
true.
Talking about it. Like, true. You're the one fair that's enough. Amplifying all this. Comedians are like, I can't say anything. It's like, yes, you can. You're just, I mean, comedians, like, we're professional complainers. You
right.
know what I mean? We'll complain about Hot Pockets for 45 minutes. You know what I mean?
That's
we'll,
kind of the nature.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, so any, our whole thing is like, freedom of speech, we should be able to say whatever we want, have any opinions we want, but you're not allowed to have an opinion about my opinion.
Are you more careful in what you'll
yeah, for sure.
you'll touch
for
now?
Sure, for sure, because it's like some things just aren't worth it.
Right,
you
that's...
know? And if it's not in the context of a stand-up special, so this is like incredibly dangerous. Like, I don't know why you're right. doing this. I
well,
don't
it's,
get
it's
it.
Not, it's not
this
live.
This is such a bad idea.
Technically, yeah.
If you fucking edit any of this, I'm recording my own. If you edit anything I say, I'm gonna go back and air it
we're,
myself.
We're pretty well, we, great with the zero, like editing people.
It, well, and it, we're, again, I trust, like, everybody. I trust the more, I don't say things that.
But I think you're, the reason I'm here is because I think your demographic is down with devil's advocate and down with people saying things. Like, comedians, we say things that are incendiary on purpose that aren't true to have an interesting conversation. When everyone agrees, it's just not an interesting conversation.
And the it's always the intent.
That's right.
To me, it's an, is the person trying to make you laugh, and not every joke's gonna hit. Yeah. But are they actually trying to like hurt someone's feelings?
But what that's I like about you is you go into dangerous spaces, and that's what comedians do. You're willing to go into dangerous spaces and like be wrong or be like, you know, have a hot take. Like, I appreciate that. And so, that's why you're you, is because you're bold and you're reckless.
Here's a move that
I mean, the jig's gonna be up soon, but
I don't know.
I mean, the fact that you're not just taking the money and running is wild. Like, why you? You're so successful. I'm fascinated with people that are rich but aren't just tapping out. Like, what do you need that you don't have?
Well, I can't tap out. So we sold, like, we've sold Barstool twice. We sold it 5 years ago to Churning Group. You probably know him.
Yes,
like,
sir.
Yeah,
yes,
because they do. They did, what's the show he had?
Peter Chernin is one of the biggest TV producers in the world.
Yeah, but he had one.
Many, he had many.
But he has one.
It's like the other day when I was
texting. New Girls.
I was texting, New Girl.
New girl. Zoe Deschanel.
Yeah, Deschanel. I was.
She's on your head.
You can't say.
Oh, because I threw up a name. I'm not exactly the name guy.
I love you, dude. But it's a form of respect to be able to talk to each other like this, right?
Yeah. But I like how he just slings it. Like, he's not like a guy that's gonna dance around the name and be like,
yeah.
I'm on the verge right before you came in of pulling a U move.
But I'm hold on. I'm learning a lot from you because if I just had a modicum of your confidence, I would have accomplished all my goals so far. I want to learn.
I mean, you're doing pretty well.
I feel like you do.
That's very nice.
You guys, I feel like you're him and a female.
Thank you.
You don't think so?
But I would never have the audacity to ask a busy, successful person to come to my house for free to be on my podcast.
That's true.
I want your confidence.
All podcast things are free.
I know, but so many people owe me favors from so long that I know that my podcast does enough numbers that I can help people. So I'm still codependent.
So do you think you're doing,
do we owe you a favor now?
No, I think this is good for you.
Michael
well.
Gruen owes me a favor for sure.
Oh, see, I don't think so.
But here's the thing, because the amount of time I turned around getting here. If you guys said, hey, in 2 weeks, will you do it? That's different. Saying, hey, can you move? I had to move three productions today to be here. So that,
that's a
we, favor. By the way, I told Gruen 100 times, like, we can do it Zoom.
Because you said, no, that doesn't do numbers. Zoom's ridiculous.
No,
Zoom. I don't think Zoom.
Well, we've never done it this
we've
way.
We've never. Our whole podcast is.
You should only do it this way.
Where I'm in New York.
You should change that. You should come out here 2 weeks a month.
I don't fucking.
Who wants to listen
here?
To a Zoom podcast? The audio sucks. I have to look at another script. I mean,
I'll be in Miami.
No, we edit it up.
Yeah,
we edit it up.
Miami.
You can't.
Maybe ask the fans. Do you guys like the Zoom podcast?
Totally.
Or do you like
in person? But
then do that.
Well, again, that's you're saying you didn't want to drive 40 minutes.
No, I'm here.
Right, but I mean, we're across the country. It's a little different. Also,
I don't think I'm doing you a favor, by the way.
Okay.
I'm doing Gruen a favor because I turn around so quick.
See, I think this is good for you as well.
Thank you.
Because I mean.
No, all your incel fans are going to hate me after this.
There's
no way this is going to go well for me.
There's a lot of Barstool fans that watch BFFs.
Yeah.
So they would like you.
And our crowd is very different. That's why we did this. We're not both like, I wanted his crowd and he wanted our crowd.
Yeah. And I don't know what crowd you want. And of like the TikTokers, I would say like, my fans are a little bit more on the side of not being super soft. Like, interesting. There's some like soft people on the TikTok world. Like, big they've time. Seen it. The yeah. comments are just like,
it's horrible.
Yeah, well, they
can't. Like, you can't make a joke on the app.
Right.
Very hard to do.
But that's also this thing where, look, I'm like, come from traditional comedy and stand up, and like, that's normal. Like, when we put our whole thing is we go on stage and people either laugh or they don't, and they go, that fucking sucked. Like, that's part of it. So, like,
oh, well, like, sometimes I know I'm funny. I'm like, oh, that's funny. But like,
totally, but like, feedback, you know, is part of doing comedy. 100%.
I'll rewatch myself. Because
I'm like,
oh,
bro, that, yeah.
But yep. it used to be in person, you know what I'm saying? Where people go like, oh, I don't like that. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, it's part of doing comedy. This whole thing where it's like,
that's true.
Performers don't want any feedback all of a sudden is like, that's not what we're signing up for. We're signing up for a bunch of people going, that sucks. Like, that's part of it.
But you live here. But I mean, like,
it's
I
like,
mean,
dude, you yeah. live here.
You're winning.
People
you're
right. love you. If you're gonna focus on the negative, that's like a choice.
It's also like everyone's nice in public. Everybody's nice. No one's ever mean. Everyone's only mean online.
Yeah, I've had a couple. I think because the stigma's around TikTok, I've had a couple guys that walk by and they're like,
"What stigma?"
It's like,
well, the wiggle dickers.
Yeah, or like the like frat guys or like all the. Every guy's just like, TikTokers are pussies. That's like their go-to word.
Okay.
Go-to like saying on us.
Okay.
So can't
it's just
sports.
Like, can't play
sports.
Yeah,
stealing girls.
Play sports.
They shouldn't be. It's like a new. But it's
the whole just, like, the just... whole like they're all gay. That's what they just mm-hmm. say. Like, every male TikToker's gay. So it's mm-hmm. like, when I've had like a couple times where I've been like either
what
like sometimes
are?
A.
Sorry, I'm wildly distracted.
This I'm learning about. Like, I'm obsessed with people that are as successful as you in their brain. And you, is it, what is it? What happened to you as a child?
I just have a gigantic brain.
You do, and your brain is incredibly
sorry,
fast. You get bored so quickly.
No, I don't. I was paying attention.
Is it an ADD thing? But Howard Stern is like this too. When he gets bored, he just changes the subject, and he's the greatest interview of all time. You don't know who that is, you should Google
Howard Stern? I've heard of
him. You should really Google him.
I think we did him on Boomer Zoomer.
I think.
You don't know Howard Stern?
I think if I like was like the face, I would be like, oh, that's Howard. He's the one with the curly, yeah, right. Long.
He's easily the greatest.
He looks.
King of all media.
Yeah.
If you want to talk for a living, you should really study Howard.
We get compared, probably. And I'm not saying it's even a category. Yeah. But as we were growing, they're like, oh, this is kind of like a new age Stern. Was
okay.
Were you a Stern fan?
I wasn't as big. I mean, I'm super aware of him, but I didn't listen growing up. I became more aware later. We had an incident. He trashed me. Like, I was on his show, and this is early Barstool.
Yeah, yeah.
I didn't love that, but
yeah.
And then we had a Sirius station, but we never. Yeah.
I feel like I was too young to listen to him on radio when I was listening to radio.
He was the original.
If that makes sense, right?
Yeah,
like,
yeah,
I listened
no,
to radio growing
young.
Up. Like, that was like a huge part of my life. I remember, and then like the big change when like everyone just went Spotify,
yeah,
Apple Music.
Yeah.
But it was like, I still use VCR when I was
Oh, that's
like
surprising to me. He's got a quote attributed to
seven,
him
eight.
That we use all the time. It's like, people who love me listen for 5 minutes. People who hate me listen for 10. That's like from. That his movie was.
But
it?
I like how you
joke polarizing. Polarizing is good though.
Polarizing is great.
Yeah, it is.
But whose career do you want? I'm just fascinated by, because you were talking about his Hollywood dead. I'm gonna eventually try to make this somewhat cohesive.
Yeah, this
whether
is
you
good.
Like it or not.
No. This is a good question.
And I think that every iteration that we're seeing of fame, this kind of we've had before, whether it was like MTV VJs, whether it was like commercial people that got famous.
Right.
I mean, the Old Spice
guy,
the
new boy band.
He got famous, that Old Spice guy. It was like getting television shows off of like some funny commercials.
Yeah.
The Dell guy did. Like, we've seen this before. And I've seen platforms come and go. I've seen MySpace come and go. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, I this isn't a new thing.
Mm-hmm. Correct.
Which is why I go like, what's the plan and how are you not gonna die in a
Well, I mean, there's like a
or
couple.
Or get a drug problem. I don't think it's healthy to get this much money.
I think here's
it's
the other
scary.
Thing. I already went through like a little bit of like a crazy party, like drinking, TMZ, little like paparazzi phase.
Because it's
like
just, it's like human being.
You know, like
age.
The Justin Bieber phase that everyone goes
honest,
through.
Anyway.
I already did that.
But I'm just saying, totally. But I'm just saying, when I was 19, I got to make a bunch of fucking mistakes in private. I got to like.
Oh, mine were very.
But also now you're only as successful as your creepiest friend. So, like, your friends might fuck up your
Is
future.
Is he my creepiest?
No, I'm just saying, oh, the Dobrik thing. I just was looking at the David Dobrik thing.
I would not like, claim him as my friend.
I know, I'm just saying, no, I'm not saying you. I'm just saying, he did. He seems like a good dude. His
Too
fucking,
good.
His
Too
friend
good.
Fucked
Too
it
good.
Up for
Too
him,
good.
Right?
Well, I always hate speculating because he seems
it
fairly involved.
Tell me, but I'm just saying, if, like, a tweet from 10 years ago, like, I don't expect anyone at 15 to be tweeting things
that
will
should,
hold up.
Yeah.
Your thoughts at 15 are fucking should not be put
and it's
on.
Like, I've had even my friends that like live in my house where like people have pulled up old things, a lot like what happened to you, Dave, where like people are pulling up old like comments from when these kids were 13, 14 years old.
Yeah.
Living in like, kids. Like either like the South or like Kentucky, like just living in like small, like shittier town, like, and like I come from like kind of like a small shitty town too. And it's like, you're kind of like, you
that
act like your environment.
That is,
you know,
different
what I mean?
Now. It.
The girl from Teen Vogue, should she have lost her job because of tweets that she posted?
That's the one we had, correct?
When she was 15?
Isn't that who we had on the show?
Who do you know?
The girl from Teen Vogue that was the editor of Teen Vogue.
I know who you're talking about.
No, lost her job. I just don't think any, and like all the thoughts I had when I was 15 up until like probably 25 should never
That's
have been written
though.
Down.
Yeah. We're in an era now where the social media has been around long enough where there
where
is
kids can make
there
mistakes.
Is a record of yeah. what nothing.
If
changed,
anything I wrote in my journals or that I thought was a good opinion when I was 15, it's like don't make permanent decisions based on temporary feelings.
See, I was lucky. My parents had a rule until I was in ninth grade where I was only allowed 30 minutes of screens when I came home.
Wow.
So it was like, I got back from school. My dad was a high school teacher and this school was on my street.
Cool.
He'd walk back home and it would be like 30 minutes after I'm home and he was like, get the fuck outside. Like, it's like.
I don't want to defend or answer him, but the question on like what his, I think he's very, he's one of the few that's very.
I would love to answer it.
I agree.
I would love to answer it if you want me to.
Yes, please.
Okay, we do the whole not answering questions sometimes, but like, I would like to answer.
Because you seem so kind and so, and I get worried.
Kind.
Because like what goes up, I always have like, I just in seeing how the internet builds people up and builds people up and then just like waits to tear them down, like waits for you to make a fucking one mistake. So that
someone could already have a tweet
from you. Do you get scared?
So here's the thing. One, I blew up with the image of like, you can't cancel me mentality. That was kind of like what-
Do you have an ex-girlfriend who you broke her heart, who one day just wants to like, do you worry about that?
I don't think so. I mean, like, we really have been like-
I'm gonna accuse you of rape in 2 years, because I need to retire.
Wow.
Fucking God.
That's a bold statement.
See, I'd be afraid to make that joke.
You just look like an ATM machine. That's all I see. Couldn't. You know, in cartoons when
like
people
the
look
money dollar signs on the eyes or whatever.
When they look at like some a person and just turns into like a turkey above their head. That's
No, but I mean, like, I even look up to, I would say, Dave when I look at, like, where I want to go with my career and everything. Same with, like, Mark Wahlberg.
Like,
I,
building
I
just, a business.
Yeah,
like
yeah,
being
exactly.
Behind the
and the pivoting.
Like, they bought those. How smart is that? The silly brands? They
so, like,
that
we just did an M&A with silly brands, yeah.
Then I just go, there's even more money to
That's
settle.
Brilliant.
That's true.
Even this, bigger this, settlement. I want to accuse you of rape even more now. Wow.
So it's like, I do a lot of things that are like on the entrepreneurial side. So I'm like,
smart.
I would say I'm one of the smarter creators that's actually setting myself up.
Yeah.
Like there's a lot of creators that are out here like buying 7 cars.
Yeah,
right?
Done.
And it's like,
by the way, Floyd Mayweather, he openly says they're leased. Like you guys are the first generations that are buying cars.
They're not buying them.
Okay, good.
They're being,
By the way, I openly tell everyone like, I didn't pay for my car.
Yeah.
Like, I got it gifted to me.
Yeah.
It's like, why the
Google
fuck would
MC
I spend?
Google MC Hammer. The
like,
money, it's never as much as you think.
I did a clubhouse.
He was
never I did a clubhouse with them yesterday night.
Yeah.
It's never as much as you think.
What?
Money.
Oh, yeah.
He's like, yeah, it is.
Well, depends.
but like, do you want to do movies? Do you want to do, like, what do you
think? So, like, when I look at, like, what makes Josh Richards, it's like, I'm going to be a movie star with the production.
Already talking
company,
first person.
Executive
is this
producer.
A red flag? This is already.
I didn't
south.
Hate the way he answered it. It's like Jimmy from Seinfeld.
You think of yourself as a business.
Yeah.
100%. That's amazing.
I mean, I've thought like that since I was, like, 12.
Love it.
11.
Love
years
it.
Old.
Love it.
And to be honest, I don't think this podcast would work if. It, like we didn't have a similar because there is obviously a huge age difference. A lot of TikTok people, I would never be able to do a consistent.
Yeah, I'm gonna toot my own horn. I would say I'm the only TikToker he could do it with.
Yeah,
probably.
I'm gonna toot my own horn here for.
Yeah, yeah, yo, please, no.
No, I would say since
you should.
I
mean, no, but you're obviously incredibly talented. It's like I'm just so curious how because being.
I mean, I invest too. Like that's a big thing. I'm an
Bill
investor.
Murray said, you know, about fame one time on Howard Stern. This always like stuck with me. Try getting rich and see if you still want to be famous.
Right.
So fame for me, I just feel like fame, like getting more famous at this point could be a liability.
It is different levels for
like
sure.
Like at what point do people go, okay, I'm famous enough, I'm gonna step away, I'm gonna be enigmatic, I'm gonna be mysterious, I'm gonna go away.
Did that happen to you?
Well, for me, as like a female comic, like when I started coming up, I mean, female comics are like the most hated species of person on the planet.
Because but that's like the cool thing about like what you've done is like you've broken out of the stigma and that's what I respect so much of like, the whole like females aren't funny thing. Like everyone always makes that joke. It's like a standard thing for like the female communities, but like you're obviously very funny.
Thank you.
I would say we're all laughing.
I don't know. You guys seem to be.
I don't love stand up in general.
Yeah.
It's like hard.
But there's
to
this new thing where if you're funny, people feel attacked because now people take jokes as facts. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. They take them literally. If you're just like, oh, because you're an idiot. I'm not an idiot. Like, no, it was a joke.
Right.
People forgot how jokes work. Yeah. At least on the internet, not in real life. So are you gonna tour?
So I actually already did do that.
Okay, how'd it go?
It was really fun. Uh-huh. I'm someone that loves that type of energy, and interacting with the fans.
And so what was it like to see your fans in person? Like was it what you expected? Were they the ages you expected?
I think that's when I had like my first like, what the fuck moment. Like I'm kind of like I'm a celebrity a little bit. Like I have like people really want to just like come pay for tickets to come see me. Like that was the craziest thing.
To be in the same building.
How do you look at that, by the way, celebrity? So like I grew up in like Robert De Niro is an A-list celebrity. Yeah. DiCaprio is an A-list celebrity. But then you get the TikTok people who are probably, and it really, I remember when TikTok started, we had Charlie in our office. I didn't know who she was. She came to Barstool. They're like, we haven't, like, who is this? I have no idea.
Yeah.
Then someone showed me a video of her at a mall. And it was like the Beatles were there. I mean, she was getting swarmed. Mm-hmm. How do you look? Like, do you consider, because he has the following, his notoriety, but he's not the traditional, star that we grew up.
My thing, it's the kind of thing that when you have people that love you, you better have a fucking product for them because they feel so invested in your fame. What I'm learning is like,
A list, B list, C list, like, where do you put his level of celebrity in your
eyes? That is an interesting question.
Well, if I knew too much about you again, like Chris Hansen should jump out and take me to jail. I've made a conscious effort to not know TikTokers under 18.
That's the Catch a Predator guy.
You do know he actually got in trouble.
Yeah, but he's a shitty guy behind.
Catch a Predator got caught. I don't think it was like predatorship, but he's
a shitty guy. Yeah.
Imagine if he
that
got
show
caught for
was
being
an all-time show.
Yeah. But imagine he got caught for being a predator. But that'd be chef's kiss.
Here's why you're invincible. Kiss. All your shit anyone can get you on, you are out there. So what people
100%.
I don't think people are out to cancel people. We are incredibly forgiving fucking Robert Downey Jr. Like woke up in a bed with a 17-year-old. He's Iron Man. We all forgave him. Mel Gibson has 14 movies in production. Like, we're not we don't really.
He's not my favorite guy.
I'm just saying, but we're actually very forgiving.
You know, I told you this. I did an independent film with Mel Gibson's son.
Whoa.
Like, weirdest just like tie into this.
Do you feel like people, because this is what happens on the TV side, which I've like, am quitting, but.
Your brain's all over the place. You say jump around. You're a mile a minute. Do you do Adderall?
I don't do Adderall. People.
This is like a natural ADHD thing going on here.
Well, no, I'm like
ADHD through.
I just feel like someone has to take control of the situation, and it's not going to be you or you.
I feel like I have.
I'd like to hear from you at some point, Bree. How are you doing?
I'm doing good.
Good.
Yeah, this is fun to watch everyone bicker back and forth.
Well, because I think we're all like.
I'm about to pull a U move. I've been trying to say it. I had the call before you came out. So someone blackmailed you with your boobs.
That's correct.
And you just put them out there.
Yes, I did. It was.
That is the most baller move I've ever.
I would do the same thing.
Did you do that?
No, I said I would. It
wasn't like even a nude that was like impressive. I have so many impressive ones.
And why would
in there.
You put it out there?
I have the best. Got my boobs done by the best plastic surgeon in Hollywood. They are incredible, except I don't have to tell you. It's the second women bend over. You know how your boobs get like long, like, you know what I'm saying? No matter how they are.
Sure, I guess.
Yeah,
you get a little buttery when you bend.
You probably haven't seen a lot of real boobs. You probably grew up with porn.
No, I've seen a lot of real boobs.
So I was hunched over in a bath. It was a screen grab of a video. So I was just more annoyed that my tits like didn't look as good as they are.
So did you take like a high quality,
put a good one out,
like ring light, maybe like production like this?
Did you know who it was?
I didn't know who it was. I got basically. He got a screen grab of it, and he basically said of something that I accidentally posted on Instagram stories when I was high on edibles in the bathtub. I accidentally posted it. Took it down. Really, he had screen grabbed it a week before my special came out on Netflix. He was like, here's a...
That sounds like I would accuse you of that being a work if you release a nude.
That's what someone else said.
It makes sense.
But you want to release the good one
first,
right?
But he came at me... a week before my special. So why doesn't he get accused for capitalizing on the fact that my special was coming out? Why do I get accused for
it? Well, that would be because
everyone's like, that was a genius PR stunt.
Would be because the people who are saying you're doing it are saying you made up the guy.
I know, but I screen grabbed the email.
People thought that me and Bryce were that.
I know, totally, but in my day, you just get success off your talent. You don't do these like PR stunts. Like I would love to learn how to do them.
I disagree.
I think there are so many PR stunts.
I understand, but not as a comic, like we don't like to take shortcuts.
Oh, comedy.
Yeah.
I mean, like there are whole careers that are just
PR stunts. Do you think Elon Musk throwing the rock at the car?
Didn't you go on Last Comic Standing?
I was on Last Comic Standing.
That's a shortcut.
I didn't even get past the first round.
That is a shortcut.
My manager was the producer. I was so in debt, I needed money. And I made $1,000.
Shortcut, though.
Mm-hmm. When I was 22.
Just saying, comics don't like shortcuts. That was, if you got selected, that's
I know,
shortcut.
But I was 22. No one at 22.
I didn't
22.
Think I'd have that in my back pocket. That's all right.
No, you did a deep dive, but I wasn't on Last Comic Standing also. I was in the...
You didn't make it.
I didn't make it. I was in the preliminary.
But you were trying. If you go on American Idol, that's not a shortcut.
No, stand-up's doing stand-up anywhere is never a shortcut. Stand-up is the hardest thing.
That is like them doing their craft.
Absolutely not.
No, but a game show.
Have you ever done stand-up? Have any of you ever done stand-up?
I see what you're saying, the difference between like a game show and like on stage.
You didn't get your fame by working in the club. You went on a TV show.
You don't even get to go on Last Comic Standing unless you can work in the club. So as someone that thinks Last Comic Standing is a shortcut in a corny show.
We're fucking wrong.
No stand-up is taking a shortcut. If a stand-up has done stand-up at any point, they're
not
taking
a shortcut. So you don't think
that's
a shortcut?
No.
That show.
I think it's corny, but I don't think it's a shortcut. Okay. Because I think to become famous as a comedian before the internet was so fucking hard, a lot of people who did Last Comic Standing had been famous in the comedy world for 30 years, and they finally got a break that they already had deserved for 20 years.
So you don't think then, like, American Idol, and a singing show, same philosophy, a lot of them are in bars and bands.
I just don't know enough about the music business to know what's merit-based and what's not. I just don't know. Like, I don't know who deserves what in music.
I pretzeled you, and now you can't do that one.
What?
I put your brain in a pretzel with
you. You actually didn't, but what?
We have the tape. We'll
yeah, no, but the tape?
Yeah, no, we have the tape.
Yes. You, every now and then, you are 44. Roll the tape.
I
put that in the VCR.
This is, first of all, I don't know how you knew the 44, because I just turned 44. Like, okay.
That just a wild guess?
No, I Googled
like 3 days ago.
No, I Googled you.
Oh, you did just.
It said you were 44 on the internet.
I am, but.
No, but to answer your question, I don't know enough about the music business. To know what a shortcut is for there. Like American Idol, I don't know. I think a lot of people deserve to be famous that aren't.
What do you think a shortcut is, being a comedian?
Like, like being funny on Twitter and thinking you're a stand-up, or like lip syncing and not. Like, if you can't go on stage and make people laugh for 45 minutes.
Not a comic.
Yeah, you're not a comic, just calling yourself a comedian is, like, don't charge people money.
Oh, I got to ask this question though.
Yeah.
I got to ask this question, remember what Quinn said.
Yeah. And if you're not
if
taking
you're
risks,
a comedian,
can I say one more thing?
Yeah.
If you're not taking risks.
Okay.
So that's the other thing. Like Shane
I would
Gillis.
Say Quinn takes risks though.
Yeah, she does.
Like a Shane Gillis, like whatever he was working, if he had done that on a stand-up stage and it was like, it's context too. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
it's like you can say something about whatever China or whatever.
Yeah.
If you're on stage, same thing with roasts. Like if I
I love you on roasts.
If I come and we're just having dinner and I'm just like roasting, I'm just being mean, but in the context of a roast, I'm just doing my job and everyone has the same expectations. I think now everyone's expectations are so off, it's hard to know when you're
can't read anything.
So this is gonna be my question every time we have a comedian on. Every single time I'm gonna ask.
I know it's coming.
Why the fuck did we do that? It's a bad idea.
Does a comedian?
We're combative just by nature.
Right. Okay. Fair enough.
Does a
comedian have to say they're a comedian? Like, do they have to publicly be like, I'm a comedian, or like, does that kind of defeat the purpose of being a comedian because you're just supposed to be funny?
Like in what? Like in your bio?
Just like out there a lot.
The goal
like,
is that it's just obvious. If you have to say you're a comedian, it's like when people have to like say there's something too many times, it's like, what's going on with you that you need to prove? I don't know. In what context?
Standard.
We had a dispute. Do you think you're trying to be funny right now?
I think I'm trying to keep my head above water.
It's like an alert.
With us, you mean, right here?
Well, no, because I can't. I think your fans want to hear more from you than they want to hear from me.
So no, they
I feel like
of
I'm
us.
Just trying yeah. to. I'm trying to get my questions answered about you guys.
Interesting. See, yeah. I don't get the vibe. You're trying to be funny. You're just funny.
Thank you.
Which is what I am. Like, I've
but
never
that's but that's enough. What I funny remember. Is.
But also,
whenever people, you know, those kids in school
that's
that were
why
like,
I don't like, stand-up. Like.
But fuck funny, dude. Anyone can go on YouTube or TikTok anytime and see funny whenever they want. We're competing with cats, like singing, dancing to Beyonce. Like, I think that interesting is the new, for a podcast, I think the goal is to be interesting.
Yeah.
No, but that was kind of like where I was going is like, you know those kids in school that like, you'll see them and they're not trying to be funny at all. They're just like doing their regular, like everyday thing. And like you just start dying laughing.
Yeah, and comedy's
like,
changing.
That's the funny shit. But then they go and try to be funny because they see you like laughing at them or something. And then you're just like, ah.
Right. It's all context. So it's like, if I'm on stage last night and I do 20 minutes on.
How often do you stand up?
A lot. Let me get to that. We are. I just want to answer this question. The people that are listening, there are so have such like emotional blue balls at this point because we're not finishing.
Oh my! Yeah.
I'm just trying to
be pissed.
Yeah, everyone's listening, like ready to be like, okay, finally they're gonna finish.
I mean, I'm sure your audience is like used to this pace. But if I go on stage and I'm like talking about Barstool Sports and TikTok and joking and everyone's. And then I come here and do the exact same thing. I'm gonna be corny. I'm gonna be forcing it. I'm gonna be hacky.
Do you have to re?
There's no audience. You know?
You don't have like a little bit of a routine at all?
Of course I do.
Okay, okay.
But not when I come to a podcast.
Right.
Because the last thing I want is people to go, Whitney tried to be funny and she's corny and she's.
She did this already in her Netflix.
She's obnoxious.
Like if you brought your sex robot, people would have been like, come on.
I should have.
I remember my favorite comedian stand up.
That would have been crazy.
And I don't like a lot of them. You can do it. Yeah, I got rid of mine. Is Chris Rock. I think he's like the best to ever do it. But I was stunned, so I was like, I'm gonna go.
Yeah,
Dave Chappelle. Toss
up. I'm gonna go see Chris Rock everywhere. Like, and I was in college. I went, saw him, then saw him, and I was stunned. And this is just me being an idiot. That like everything was the same. Like it was like going to like a concert. I was like, wait a minute. I've heard the timing, the mannerisms, all of it.
Yes.
That was like I didn't know.
It's something that we compose. You know, I mean, this is.
But it really is a show. You're putting on a. Yeah, it's an like
it's a live movie.
That's why comedians are good actors.
It's Saturday Night Live, and
because you're basically pretending you're coming up with it every night.
Exactly.
I'm fascinated by you. If anyone's like, oh, Whitney's disrespectful to a TikTok, like people are like TikTok stars. I have so much respect for what you guys do because what we do, we work on it for 8 months. We have 8 months to figure it out, get it right. Then we shoot it 4 or 5 times. Then we intercut it, make sure it's great. We get to get it and edit it, then put it out. You're just like shooting stuff in like 20 minutes and putting it out. Like I don't have that skill. Like I'm completely
fascinated. But you do, and I don't follow you enough on social media. Like I feel like if you put, you're welcome. If you put like, and maybe you're doing, but if you went on TikTok, any platform, and you were just, I'm gonna make minute like vignettes of me being very funny, I feel like you would be very popular doing that. Maybe you do it.
I don't know enough about TikTok. Like, I just don't.
Wait, whoa. You could do that
on
TikTok.
I'm not on anything.
So we're about to make you owe us a favor here.
So
Dave's about to make you owe us a favor.
But that is
just
what.
Get on TikTok.
But that.
What are you doing?
I've heard.
Put like, you literally would have 100 videos from like just your Netflix.
I just need to know. Like, there's people on TikTok that have 8 million followers on TikTok, but only 20,000 on Instagram. Like,
well, those are fake.
No. That's not true. That's not fakers. You know what it is?
What?
Here's what it is. And this is like something like I figured out really early in social media, but there's like two types of creators, right? There's people that create content and it just goes, they create like viral content. Mm-hmm. So those are like, a lot of the times they're really like clean, cringy people.
How did you just make your hair worse by fixing it?
Sometimes it just happens,
incredible.
You know? Like, see? Anyways, it's drying. I had like this stupid perm.
At some point, you gotta hit her back with the fact she has blue hair.
Blue hair. Like,
The fact that you're not roasting me.
I have like the smurf jokes. I have like the Dixie lookalike. Like, she's trying to like be young again. Like, I got a catalog here, and I'm just like, she looks straight out of Riverdale right now. It looks like she just came off of the set of Riverdale.
Don't even know what that show is. The funny thing is, I'm too old for you to hurt my feelings because I don't even know what the references are.
Yeah,
I didn't even know what you're talking about.
God damn it.
Fuck. You can't even hurt me. Sorry. So there's two kinds of creators.
Yeah. So there's like the people that are like pretty cringy is just what I would call it.
Corny.
It's like the little kids like it though, right? Like if you're from 4 to 8, which
it's
is
easy
weird
to watch.
That most people are on social
easy
media.
Easy to understand.
But it's like whatever. Yeah.
Translates internationally. Because you have to translate internationally.
Exactly. They have the Brazilian, they have like all those fans, right?
Asia,
and it's like
whatever.
The thing about those fans though.
What?
When you make like a you know
that's a translate internationally.
Like Lele Pons.
No, there's TikTokers
you know
that are big in other
talking
countries.
About
what am I? What do you mean, what am I talking
your
about?
Your fans aren't all from the United States. This is a global platform.
TikTok,
you can check, too.
Dude, I mean, like, I could literally pull up. I think my biggest city is in Brazil.
For real?
I mean, like.
What good does that do?
Most of the, okay, Amanda Cerny
I'm just saying if I ever go to a Brazilian
India for a
tour,
month a year.
I think she hates me. Yeah.
Amanda Cerny.
I wouldn't be, I mean.
Why?
I can't imagine anyone hating you.
Actually, she.
Come on.
Does she hate, who is she?
Hold on. A lot of these fans are international, right?
Yep.
They're not all American. Full stop. Like, do you know your metrics of where everyone is?
I give you the best advice. That's what Barstool's good at, by the way. Mm-hmm. Like, you're fun. You should be on. We morph quickly mm-hmm. to the platforms to get
so
our voice out there.
My second biggest city is New York now, by the way.
Oh.
Which is sweet. But my biggest is Sao Paulo or whatever the fuck that is.
Uh-huh. Are you going to, like, go there? Because that's where your fans are.
I mean, no, 1% of 7.3 million people is, like, a great amount of people for that city, I'm sure. Right? Like, for a city like that.
Yeah, you should go there. Never if seen your a fans creator. Are there, you have
this
to go
Amanda
there.
Cerny?
Mexico City.
That's Amanda Cerny.
Really?
Yeah.
She's a model or a comedian?
She was big on Vine, and she's a big content creator and, like, YouTuber.
This is not who I thought hated.
Country.
Oh, no. I don't think she hates anyone. She's awesome.
Like, all right, good.
Yeah.
But I'm just curious, like, in your business plan, do you go, okay, these are where my fans are, I go there. Like, how...
We look at that for, like, definitely, like, speeches. If you go to, like, a paid speech, or, like, if there's, like, maybe content. A lot of times, like, the travel, like, you know how there's, like, Travel Mexico or whatever, right? There's, like, the traveling tourism companies down there.
Sure.
They'll pay for us to go.
Yeah.
You just had an epiphany.
What did you find?
I got to ask this before.
It's crazy.
I don't want it because, so, Alex, we're doing Alex Cooper next.
Love her so much.
So you have this tweet, because I was in the middle of that, and right here.
Yeah.
The caller daddy girls need to call me. I'll sort this out.
Yeah. When I saw that, I was fat. That's when I really sort of got to know you, and
So why didn't you at Dave? He asked you.
Well, that was, she was chirping like, I had
I get on Twitter, I get in, I get the fuck out.
That was
I don't hang that out
was a
there.
One. That was, she's don't like, is anyone it. Doing anything good on Instagram Live during the quarantine? I was doing the unboxing, which was like, must watch.
You're doing
shit.
A FabFitFun part of
the show. Yeah, like, how are you going to?
How much money, like, we need to, who is stealing from you that you're still doing things for money?
Me?
We need to talk to your business manager.
I do it for content.
Yeah.
It's like, we run a company. And like,
Dave's a man of the
people. I didn't answer it. We
you
sold
have
our
siblings?
Company.
Great guy.
My sister. We sold our company, I signed a 5-year contract.
Mm-hmm.
So,
oh,
like,
so you...
I don't own any equity in Barstool
uh-huh.
anymore.
Oh,
I own it in this company called Penn, which it's been great, but it's a gambling.
So it's like a 5-year vest?
It's a 5-year vest, yes.
I'm fascinated by what drives people, and you have an incredible drive, and I'm just fascinated. And also, you know that, like, is the statistic 30% of people in the top 1% of every field are psychopaths or sociopaths? So I always like to...
I'm more psycho than social. I don't think
there's
I'm
a
don't
different
think you're a sociopath.
I don't know.
I hope not.
What's
no, you show emotion.
Sociopath,
doesn't show emotion.
That's right.
No
doesn't
empathy.
Feel empathy. And then, but a psychopath, the difference, I believe, just because I've dated a lot of them, and I've been in the business of Hollywood for 15 years.
But sociopaths can, like, almost deliver fake.
But they can function.
They have
really very.
Good ones,
they can be
right?
very
yeah.
highly
yeah.
functioning.
Yeah.
yeah.
And a lot of the people that we come in contact with on a daily basis just statistically are psychopaths and sociopaths.
Well,
a lot of people have told me I have sociopathic tendencies, which I don't
Someone
know.
Someone said that about you?
Like Michael tells me it all the time.
Oh, why?
Okay, you're gonna
He's a psychopath.
Don't listen to any.
Oh,
that
I, by
says.
The way, like I
the fact
I'm
that you're
very
taking advice from someone
like
that's smoking
like,
Marlboro Reds with his pants open is wild.
Well, it's usually just the flies down or something.
Yeah, that's that. You can't do that in a business setting.
But it's awesome because it's just like.
Do you guys have an HR? Like, do you have an HR department?
Yes,
like,
what Barstool
it's
does
just
now.
Like
we're remembering.
I'd like the number.
I'm remembering all these things now, and this could go on for hours. But so we gotta,
really we could do like a
you know,
3-hour
when
special.
We had
I know.
Our
That's what I
we,
said.
We had a TV show that was getting pitched, and you know what was the one that?
Why would you do TV?
This was years ago,
mm-hmm.
and
you would lose money in TV. Like,
no, this was years ago, but it was Chelsea Handler's the show that I wanted to be Chelsea Handler meets. Pardon the interruption, which is a sports show.
Yeah.
You were on that as well. I always thought it was brilliant. I don't know now, she seems a little off the reservation.
Well, me, I think comedians feel this pressure to be like political or something. And
yes,
I
that's
just,
where she was like.
Which is, if that's your thing, that's like great, but I think comedians in my, I would like to just stay funny all the time. You don't need
I
to know how
like
I vote. You don't need
yeah,
to know.
If you're in that field though, you should probably just be like.
I always say with us, people don't believe it, but I use the Michael Jordan quote with us, like blue states and red states buy t-shirts from us. So like, I want them all buying. I want all tickets. Yeah.
My job is not to preach to
right.
you or tell you you're wrong or that you vote wrong. My job is just to make you laugh. And if I can't do that, I've failed.
I mean, for me, it's pretty easy because every time I'm just like, I'm Canadian. So when they hit me, like they
would
easily hit me like, because I've done a couple like, I was on like Fox
yeah,
Business.
Yeah, stay out of politics. Like,
I was on like Fox Business and they hit me randomly. Like we were doing
yeah,
a whole,
sure, yeah.
we were doing like a whole, like it might've been talking about Triller or something. And then out of nowhere, they're like, so what do you think about like Trump and like,
nope.
something like that? And
nope.
I was like, I just pulled the like, I'm Canadian, man. What are you
yeah,
talking about?
Yeah, you don't know anything. Be as like mysterious as possible.
I interviewed Trump. So that definitely put me in the people, but they didn't listen to it. Like, yeah. It doesn't matter. If you go on Fox News, people say you're one way. If you do something else, it's
Do you think the media, like, since we're getting two sets of media now and you're kind of this media mogul, like, what's going to happen given the fact that we're just, people are getting two sets of news and are operating on different sets of facts? Like, do you think that media should be private?
I think social media is going to become just more and more every day than new media.
It's the news.
Well,
people are going to want a man. Things that aren't true. Do you know what I'm saying? Yeah, used to be like journalists, they had to vet it, they had to fact check it, and then they put it out. Now people that don't know what they're talking about are saying things and it looks true.
I don't know.
Like, do you think media should?
But I feel like people don't.
I don't know,
like,
that that's true. I think there's obviously.
You think everything QAnon people post is?
No. What you just said is true. I agree.
I'm just saying I can go and
everybody
find.
Everybody has an angle and lying, trying to create.
I don't know that Candace Owens isn't right.
I don't think that's new. That's all I'm saying.
That's interesting.
I think that's been going on forever, but social media
just amplifies it or like shows it towards.
Correct. But I think from the beginning of time, who's ever controlling media,
they
have an angle. Mm-hmm. And what is it? History is told by the winners.
And a motive. Like, yes,
so
you're right.
I just don't think that's a new thing. It's just.
And headlines have always been clickbait, even when it was a newspaper, extra read all about it. That's interesting.
So, but it's definitely, and I firmly believe, like, I hate the extreme left, I hate the extreme right.
Yeah,
I think 98% of the people are normal in the middle, but everything is torn apart. Agreed. It sucks. Yep.
But we also have to stop focusing so much on that tiny sliver 100%. On Twitter, because that's our narcissistic addiction.
100%. 100%.
If Alex Cooper is coming, I mean, what more could you possibly want from me?
Yeah, well, how are you going to fix that?
What?
You said you want to fix Caller Daddy.
Oh, no, this was during the fight.
Yeah, right.
Well, because it was like, I think it was like right during the ambiguous time where they didn't know if they were going to go forward. And it was just my way of going, I'll be the co-host.
Did you listen to that?
I didn't listen to it, but I watched Alex's video and I was totally taken with her. And I think
she's a monster. She's a
star. Yeah, I'm just a fan. And it is my goal to get famous wearing hoodies. So she is, in my day, you had to fucking try.
I had to wear
fucking push-up bras and mini skirts from 20 to 30.
That's very true. It's different.
Women
now.
Couldn't dress like this and be on television or have opportunities. Mm-hmm. Like, I come from the time where you had to like show up and be a little thought and had to like flirt in order to be on camera.
Black glasses.
Like, I would pull a full Sharon Stone. If this was 10 years ago, I'd be in a mini skirt just like showing my pussy.
You know why? You're pretty.
Thank you.
So you got caught because, and I'm not saying she's not, but there's a comedian, female.
Don't drag me into this.
Black glasses. I'm not on. Black hair, very funny, but she dressed very drab, not.
Sarah Silverman?
No, I like Sarah Silverman.
She's thought of as, I mean, she's stunning.
Yeah, no, that's not who I'm talking about.
Oh.
She.
Started in Boston or did a lot in Boston?
Black hair,
slate.
Black round glasses.
Black glasses.
Charlie
Neal.
Female. She's probably is not too many female comedians.
Right. That's okay. You don't. I mean.
But
you're about to say something that probably shouldn't be said. So let's just switch. Now's the time to change
the
subject.
You said you had to wear push-up bras and look sexy. She did not. That's
right. I'm saying as an actress, not as a comedian.
Oh.
Definitely. As a comedian, is the opposite. The comedian, I had to neuter myself and wear hoodies and no makeup.
So
and
you
put
tried
my hair
to be
on.
An actress first.
I
didn't know that.
Yeah. I had a TV show called Whitney for 2 years.
I did see that though.
Yeah, your parents probably saw it. Your dad's probably jerked off.
Oh, you're on this thing. Nice.
All right. My parents both listen to this podcast.
No, they don't.
No, they do.
Shit ton. I take this podcast back.
Good.
Shit ton.
Yeah, they're going to watch it together, actually.
They're either going to love me or hate me.
I'm taking it.
They're
going to
be
they
like,
probably
thank
already
you.
They're going to
be like, thank you,
you
for
you.
Parenting.
There's a thank you for telling my son to clean the house.
There's a shit ton of funny female comedians. I'm taking that back.
A ton.
This list.
Yeah, we already knew that.
But stand-ups are, there's SNL comedians, there's sketch comedians, there's stand-up comedians.
Oh, her.
Who's the one that did the movie like, who's the bigger girl that's like
Melissa McCarthy?
I'm not saying she's
a comedian.
I'm saying in my day to be on TV, to be like a host, to be on, you had to look like a little
hot.
To be on
Janine
G4.
Garofalo.
Janine Garofalo was a fucking movie star, dude.
Yes.
She was a movie star.
But
reality,
she was stand up, wasn't she?
Yes, she was. Reality Bites. She did a movie with Uma Thurman. I mean, that was back when like. If you were a successful comic, you became a movie star. Whoopi Goldberg was a movie star. Pauly Shore was a movie star. He was. He was. You don't have to have liked the movies, but he was a movie star.
I don't know if I've ever seen such a like spit take.
That was preposterous.
He was a movie star.
That is a little bit. That is a little bit.
That's true, nice just too true.
Pauly Shore is a movie star.
He was a movie star.
He was
star.
In movies.
He starred in movies.
Hey,
he number
hey,
one on the call sheet.
Whose water
number
is
one
that,
on the call
though?
Sheet.
What's that?
Is this your water?
I think someone might have gotten it for me, but it feels a little bit
roofied,
like a
feed, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah. I don't.
I'll test it out.
Yeah,
she wants to get out of here alive.
I just Whitney just went night.
Yeah, right.
But yeah, no, he was a movie star. You can't pretend he Encino Man and all those whatever G.I. Joe, G.I. Tract wasn't real. I'm not happy about it either.
Pauly Shore is a movie star.
He was a movie star.
If you star in a movie, or
can you look up Pauly Shore?
His movies were massive at that time. Because here's the thing, but people got so famous. I feel like TikTok's the new like MTV. MTV was the biggest thing in the world when I grew up. Now it's TikTok.
Right.
And then if
you're super.
By the way, you didn't answer the question.
Don't turn out like this, is all I'm saying.
You didn't answer the question of where you put me in the category of A, B, or C list celebrity.
Because I'm not totally sure yet, because I do know that in TV for the last couple years in casting, that we'll be like, oh, we're casting this part. And they'll go, like, can we get this TikTok star? This one. Like, and then they learn that the numbers don't translate. Like your fans
well,
you get
need,
to see
you.
You
need
the time.
More than just like, and this goes to the engage.
Like Hollywood's
the,
trying to use
the
you
two
guys
creators
to
thing,
be relevant.
So this goes to the two creators
what I,
thing
that's
too.
What I, that's how I judge it. If a creator on TikTok has big on other followings, then I assume they're legit. If they don't, I don't trust.
Do your fans want you for free like this, or will they actually go find you, tune in at a certain time, and help another show that is not just yours?
I mean,
I don't know.
My fans help.
They follow, yeah, for sure.
They'll probably follow, like Liza Koshy's will follow her to your show, but if you're on fucking Modern Family, are they gonna go, okay, where's the...
They will.
I just don't know.
They do.
I think so, because I think they should.
They
follow me, to Barstool. They follow me to WFAN radio hits.
Do they even know how to find ABC, though? Do they even know what ABC is?
Oh, yeah.
Well, that's a different question.
I mean,
no, but I don't know if I could. If you gave me a remote, I don't think I could find ABC. I just go to Netflix, or I just go to Apple TV.
But I also think where you're going to be seeing a lot of like TV is going to change.
That's true.
I also think that there's going to be like a lot of SVODs.
Someone's just
going to
Google
like
Modern Family.
He's an exception. There's few of them, but there are there.
I'm on his side. I'm just saying, do your fans even watch traditional television? I don't know if they do.
Yeah. I don't know if they. I mean, like, I can't answer that.
Yeah, they do. I bet they'd follow.
I'm sure they. Yeah. I'm sure. Yeah, they do. But they watch whatever.
So right now, if Riverdale says we want you to come do 5 episodes,
I probably would say no.
You know what?
Really?
Because of where I want to go with my brand. I don't think that matches my brand. I'm gonna follow a brand. I'm not gonna just start doing things left and right because it's a bag.
Wow.
You know what?
But there's no money in TV.
The boxing.
If you executive produce too, though, and I have a production company with Mark Wahlberg, so I get
that's
the
blow your mind
double hedge.
Like, almost made a face. You went,
nope. Nothing
surprising in TikTok.
I know how the TV business works. If you're creating it and if it gets syndicated, you'll make money.
But the celebrity boxing, that.
Or unless you have a deal. If you get about, you could probably get like a big deal, like an overall deal.
No, because I decided I didn't want to do that. So like I could have either went to like a random like Warner, like all these different.
For other people, you know what I'm saying?
You'll right. Leave. I could have done that, got a big check.
This is do be 50 Cent.
That's
what I'm saying. Vitamin water. Like this is this guy is fucking. I'm gonna be working for you one day. It's gonna be so embarrassing when you're my boss.
No, I decided.
I know, like this is my future. I feel like.
Kind of like I mean like with Dave a little bit like. It's the same with Mark. It was like going to team up with this like whole, like what the fuck? Who's gonna guess that I'm gonna do this collaboration? Like no one saw this, this coming.
No.
No one ever
it's
saw
really
that
smart.
Coming. And then it's the same with the Mark thing. Like everyone just started going crazy, like headlines everywhere. There was like a bunch of even like TikToks being
But a lot
made.
Of older people are gonna try to use you to be relevant. I'm not saying that's what Mark is doing. I'm just saying like it is.
You're saying that's what Dave's doing.
Yeah, well, obviously, because he's a smart businessman.
No,
well, no, it's
I need to learn business.
I'm not doing podcasts with somebody who doesn't bring us something.
No, this is a fascinating.
Yeah, exactly.
This is why I'm here. It's a fascinating combination. And why are you so normal? Good parenting?
Very good parenting.
Okay.
And like that hit me a little bit when you said I didn't have good parenting because of the cleaning thing. I'm gonna be.
Oh, that was a joke. For those
I know it was a joke, but my parents are going to be a little like...
But I wasn't on camera for that.
It was before.
I didn't say it on camera.
Was it before?
Yeah. He's on camera so often that he doesn't even understand like
he thinks everything's
that's
been
not recorded.
Like, to the point where like you don't even know I'm on camera literally all the time.
I know, but I purposely said that off camera because he doesn't even understand the concept of a private conversation.
Oh, I don't know how to wrap this up.
Do you censor all of
your
conversations?
Okay, we got to wrap it up.
Oh, we do.
It's an hour. Straight out.
So for everyone
wow,
listening,
that went
I'm so
quick.
Sorry. There's no way this is going to have gone well for me.
me.
Well, you,
but thank you for having me.
I think people
me.
Are really going to like you.
I think so, too.
Very pessimistic.
You think? No, I just think coming on to other people's podcasts, I always am like, they don't want to hear from me. They want to hear from you guys.
Well, I have one more
girls
question
like
I need
you.
To ask.
Please.
Have you ever just bombed? Just bombed
of
a show,
course.
Booed off stage?
Not booed off stage.
Okay.
But the first like 8 years of doing stand-up, you're basically bombing. And if you're not bombing, even after you're famous, you're not taking risks and you're not doing anything new and you're not performing for people that aren't your fans. So the biggest thing right now, challenge for comedians now is like, we are going back on the road. Theaters are going to be open in the fall,
yep.
but comedy clubs aren't open in a way that, like, you know, Chris Rock goes out of, part of the reason he's so fucking good is like, he goes out of his way to stop by the Comedy Store, mm-hmm. midnight on a Tuesday, yeah. people that are not there to see him, they weren't expecting him, they didn't pay to, and then it's like, it's fair again, because mm-hmm. you'll plateau if you don't constantly put yourself in front of audiences.
You gotta always push yourself though.
Totally, so it's like, if someone's already paid $100 to come see you, they're already invested in laughing and you can kind of, but if you go in front of someone else's audience, if I walked on stage on one of your shows, I'd have to fight tooth and fucking nail, and that's when you really find out if I'm a good comic or not. Not if I can
right.
make people that already love me laugh. I already have them. But if I can go and get your fans to me, that's a true comic. So if I opened for you, I'd probably eat shit for the first 15 minutes, and I'd have to fight tooth and nail to get them to laugh.
I don't know.
So you should always be bombing. You should always be,
right.
or else you're not trying.
It's the same thing with like social media when you add depth. Going on to like this podcast, first podcast I did, there was like definitely some guys that like still pulled the whole like, Josh is a pussy, and like I'm not gonna fuck with the TikToker. But then slowly and surely, like you see like comments were starting to be like, oh, actually fuck with this Josh kid. He's a normal kid. Like he's the one TikToker I think I could probably just like hang out and drink a beer with. Like
but
those
you should
types of
be.
Shit.
If you're not getting haters and people being jealous of you, you're not.
You're not doing
anything. Right.
It's part of it.
Polarizing again.
Whoever
going
told
back
anyone
to that.
You're gonna be rich and famous at 19 and everyone's gonna love you? Like it's never. It's just this is the deal.
No, I don't think I really get affected by the like hate too much too because like I started social media when I was 14 though.
Yeah.
So like I was hated in my high school. Just like going through high school.
But also, people who weren't TikTokers were. Because my last name was Cummings. Like, you know what I'm saying?
It had to be quite a bit.
Everyone gets bullied for something.
Right.
It might as well be, he's a fucking famous TikToker. That's the best thing to be bullied for.
That's very true.
Yeah.
You look back on it.
But it's like, it's not great to get roasted for like, you're a kid trying to do Musical.ly and you have like, 20,000 followers.
Yeah.
That's when it's like.
Yeah. But it's good. It's toughened you up and prepared you.
Oh, yeah.
Thank all those haters. Be like, thank you for making me strong because now you're going to.
Oh, and like I always say, like if I wasn't the kid doing the Musical.ly, I would have been the kid making fun of the Musical.ly.
Because you also need some adversity. It's good that you had a little bit of adversity so that you can, you know.
Of course. Thank my friends all the time for making fun of me too.
Yeah, when you started, yes.
Mm-hmm. All right, I know we have to wrap this up.
I'm glad you came.
I apologize to your fans.
40 minutes now, you're gonna go back.
Apologize to your fans.
Our fans are gonna like
it. I'm apologizing to them.
I think everyone's.
So now, like you, all right, how many?
They want to hear you talk. I mean,
I'm kind of like the mediator.
Okay.
Yeah.
How'd this go?
It was good.
She got added late to the podcast.
Yeah, I got added.
It was awesome. But like, great idea.
Yeah.
The amount of people I've had come up to me and like,
it rounded it out.
Great idea. We needed a female. We needed the female perspective.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, no, you let her talk a lot. She's really.
Yeah, I would say.
Her perspective is really.
You sucked all the air out of the room. So I mean, you can't be
I felt like the wind was knocked out of me this whole conversation. Yeah. I was like, I was trying to gasp.
Also, my podcasts are like 3 hours long. I kind of do what Rogan does, and it's sort of like so. But now I'm feeling like
I can tell your podcast is 3 hours long because I feel like
this could
have went
go on
3 hours
and
been smooth.
Alex come. What? All right, for people, let's be fair. Name your podcast and when does it air, or do you do a rotating schedule like he does and you just drop it whenever?
I do. It's called Good for You Podcast. It comes out every Wednesday, Wednesday nights.
So who are the last bunch of guests you've had? Kevin Nealon today.
I had, I'd like to mix it up. So I had like Hannah Stocking.
Don't know who that is.
Okay.
You guys?
Yeah.
Social media?
Yeah. Hannah, I did a bunch of social
Liza.
Media. Liza Koshy I just had on. Kesha, there's a singer.
Dude, Liza was David's ex.
Yes.
You ask her about that?
I did.
What'd you say?
But I asked her, I basically was like, hey, this is all anyone ever asks you about? I'm not going to ask you about it because I think you deserve to.
Oh, I think you meant like the recent rape allegations.
Yeah.
No, I had Liza on before all that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And then Paris Hilton was on. Is that she? I'm already not getting shot. This means someone more successful.
It's Alex.
It means that we've run way long.
Yeah. but you can Google it and find it. And then you guys, we can let you guys go. Into your next podcast.
Sweet. All right, thank you.
Thanks,
guys.
Nice
what a pleasure
to meet
you guys.
You.